so good. Yes. That is a beautiful dash.
There's an air drill. I got a few people joining. I see Monty.
So, hey everyone. Welcome to the stream. Yes, it's true. We are in the last field. Technically the last field of plants.
Hopefully last.
2020. About 7,400 acres when we finish this. Dad's in one field over about a mile from here, but he'll be wrapping that up hopefully not too long. So we'll see who finishes first, but we should be the last. But we're putting chickpeas in the ground. These are Sawyers, and we're in the 600 big bud. And he's driving.
Yeah, fuck no hands.
Yeah. I'm just riding. It's like the first time for a while sitting in this seat. I will say this corner's not that comfortable. It's not terrible. It's just not as comfortable as you would think. But yeah, so that's what's happening, guys. Thanks for joining. I don't know how long it's gonna take to finish this field. I don't know if the stream will go to the end of the field. It could be a while. It could be not a while if you just speed it up, leg arms. Stop taking forever.
Some kids.
So this is in the 600. This tractor we went through last spring and then this last fall. It took a while to finally get it completed. Not 100% there yet. There's a lot of leaks in the engine area that were from before, and they've gotten worse, so we've got some work to do to this thing. But you can see there's the Pro 700.
I gotta stop it and fix that.
And there's a blockage monitor from Intelligent Ag, and there is a blockage in that one right there. So Leg Arms is gonna jump out and he's gonna find that blockage and fix it. These chickpeas are a lot bigger. Oop, that's a wide angle. These garbanzo beans are a lot larger than like the yellow peas or wheat that we're seeding. So a lot of blockages are happening in the runs out there. But thanks to the Intelligent Egg blockage system, we can find them. It's just a matter of getting out there to dig them out. So I'm just here to hang out with you guys. I would be spraying, but it's a little windy outside. And right now crops are coming up and I really don't feel like drifting in the neighbor's yard. So yeah, hold off on that. But he's going to get out, he's going to stop, get that blockage taken care of, and I'm going to take the captain's chair and hang out. So, got a lot of people here from Alberta. Lots of good stuff. Bow Island, nice. Hey guys, welcome, welcome, welcome to the channel. As you can see, I'm flying the POWMI flag right now. There's a reason for that. It'll come in a future video, but we put that up for right now. Leg Arms has taken off. He's had it. I'm gonna steal this chair. Ah, that's much better. Ah. Not that I don't mind this corner here, but this is a 4x4 chunk of steel that just sticks out. There's no backrest. So, yeah, could be better. Should we watch Leg Arms do his job? He thinks he knows where the block's at, so he's gonna go dig it out. You can see in the background, there's the Sweetgrass Hills, right there. So that's West Butte. That's my brother, Scott Welker, who a lot of times people don't understand, but his name has been given Leg Arms by the channel and other stuff, so we call him Leg Arms. But he's a good guy, he's a really hard worker, and he's been in this tractor the most out of anybody. Spin over to this side. So here's our Pro 700. This thing is really nice. It's been amazing so far. Took a little bit getting set up. We had some issues with a wiring issue from a factory harness that needed a crimp that was bad, and one of the wires took forever to find. We ended up finally finding it, but it's all set up. So we have just seed left in this tank right here. The other back two are empty. There is a little bit of chickpeas left in a truck way over here. So when we get down, we're gonna take that truck and finish filling it up with what's left in there into here, but that won't happen for a little while. And the blockage monitor says there's nothing happening right now. That's fairly normal. But this has been pretty awesome. We're loving this monitor. This has been a major upgrade in this tractor. This Pro 700 is tied into a guidance system. There's I think it's a 372 antenna on the roof up here. So it's an integrated hydraulic system, so no more Easy steer motors turning your steering wheel. This is just solid as is. And then down here, this is a new shift pad that we got from a farmer up in Canada who's got a big bud. And he got tired of the old shift box that's outdated and they don't have any updates for it because they have lots of problems like the one that we had. So he sent us that one. It's the second one that's been made. And he's basically using us as guinea pigs to help try out and make sure that the bugs are all worked out of it. But it is awesome. It is shifting really nice. Shifts really nice. Way smoother than the other transmission shift box did. And this is actually, well, it's actually electronic. It's smarter. If the old ones was old technology from like the 70s. This is like new, and it's got big butt on it too, which is pretty cool. So loving that. I'm not gonna touch it because he's out there somewhere, and the last thing I wanna do is run over leg arms. I think I see him right there. See if we can get a picture on him. See him? You guys see him moving around down there? Yeah, there he is. I think I see an arm, or maybe that's a leg. Is that a leg or an arm? I think it's a leg. That's definitely a leg. Definitely a leg. That's as far as I can zoom, so that's the hose he's working on right there. I could go out there. It's a little windy. I suppose I should, because, well, I don't know when we're going to be stopping again next, so let me grab my battery pack here. Oop, I just unplugged it. Oop, there we go. I got lots of battery in my phone. Ooh, let's zoom out. I'm zoomed in on my face. There we go. Okay. I'll plug this battery pack in later. I don't need it right now. I just got a text message from AT&T saying I've used up 70% of my data. Uh-oh. That's okay, it's unlimited. They just start throttling me, supposedly. Oh, there he comes, never mind. I'll just give you a quick lowdown of the tractor. We'll go on the outside here and take a look while we're out here. Is that what blocked it?
No, it was mud when it went down to that dip.
Oh.
It smashed mud up into it.
Those are the chickpeas. Or garbanzo beans. It's a little windy out here.
So these ones here are cherry flavored.
Here, one second. The microphone probably can't hear you. There we go.
These ones are cherry flavored and blueberry. Really
good. Or is that grape?
I don't know. I mean, I haven't tried it yet. I just, something like that.
You're not supposed to eat treated stuff, just so you know. It's not good for you. Here's the tractor. It's running really good. She's been a hard worker this year. Oh man, there's a little bit of coal. So yeah, like I was saying about oil leaks, if you guys weren't in here earlier, there's some big covers on this engine here and they've been seeping oil everywhere. And well, we didn't mess with the engine when we did the work to it, but it needs taken apart. The only way to fix that stuff is literally have to pull the engine out and work on it. And I don't know. We'll see when we get to that spot, but for now, let's go back up in the track. Okay. All right. Okay, let's get some comments here. I'm watching from DFW, Texas. Nice. Good job. Yeah, this thing smokes a little bit when you first give it some gas and it cleans up. It's just the
engine. Uses gas?
Yeah, gasoline. Runs on gasoline, I think.
I thought it ran on happy.
It might run on happy. It runs on our happy. We've been pretty happy with it. She's been doing pretty good. Doing pretty good. He's been running about 1,700, 1,800 RPM, about 5 miles an hour. Pretty good deal. So, let's see. Nice buds. It is a nice bud. This is a nice tractor. I've been really happy with it. Really happy with this thing. I'm sitting behind leg arms, so it's kind of hard to put him in the camera all the time, but once in a while I'll pan over to show his face. He's got something important to say. My car runs diesel, nice. Actually, most European cars run on diesel. Americans are slow, I guess, to figure that out, but no. How many bushels does a C-car hold? 430. 430 if you pack it tight. We're only using two of the three tanks in it, because we only have two coarse, very coarse, or extra coarse rollers in the front and the back tank. So that way we're only running the two, and that's fine. Yeah. Hello from Wisconsin, awesome. Tyler Shepherd, Montana. Yes, we're in Montana, if that's what the question was asked. Watching from Canada, a lot of Canadians planting right now. You guys are getting going. Some have been going for a while. The border to Canada is right there behind that mountain, that little hill. Where, oh, it's got dark. Come on, there we go. That right there basically is Canada, right on the other side of that thing. So yeah, it's doing well. Big Boots doing really good. I was in him this morning. I did about another 320 acres this morning with him, and then parked it when the wind picked up. And then I did some shuttling around. We did some filming for a special thing, which is why that flag is up there, and others too. So got that done, and I figured now would be a great time to do a live stream, hanging out with the Welker Bros in the Big Bud on the last maybe like 80 acres. No, probably more now.
100 acres?
80 acres.
Yeah, there's probably 100 acres left on that.
100 acres left, and at 25, 30 acres an hour, that's like a couple hours of live streaming, so maybe we'll get it all done in this live stream. Brute stream later. I might. I don't know if I'll get back into Brute later. Maybe. Very possible. Charlie, $2. If you had to change from Big Buds, what would it be?
You know, a very good question. Probably one of those Hot Wheel cars, you know, like the one I was in when we got those side-by-sides. But a Big Bud style Hot Wheels. Are those Hot Wheels?
I don't know what that thing is. Some kind of kid car. You know, I don't know. I'd probably look at either. Obviously, we'd like a Steiger. I mean, that would be a big deal. Case IH for sure.
That would be awesome.
We're familiar with a lot of that, and you know, we bleed red too. There's a lot of good tractors out there. We would definitely probably check that out first.
I mean, it would be fun to try a Versatile, a Steiger, a John Deere, Challenger. I think it'd be fun to like have all of them in a field just to see. They all have like good qualities and bad qualities about each one, or competitive things, and it'd just be fun to try them.
Yeah,
but
tractor shootout.
Yeah, there you go.
I guess they call it. That would be pretty cool.
That'd be awesome to see.
No, but I after running that, it was a 580 last year. No, yeah, it was a 580 quad track last year. It was pretty nice. It'd be kind of hard to pass up. It's kind of interesting right here. you guys see that stake right there? Well, right below that stake is actually a gas line, natural gas line running. Oh, it's really dark. Can't even see because of the dust. There's a big ditch here he's driving through, so hang on a second. There we go. Get through that.
You better watch the car.
Flip around here. Pretty good washout right there. It takes a minute to get through. Hello from the Philippines. Wow. That's a ways from now. All right. Congrats on planning 2020 from Wisconsin. Thank you. Anne-Marie, love you guys. Is this the Anne-Marie that we know? Maybe not. I don't know. But if there is an Anne-Marie, I know it. But Canada. So if it is, thank you. Hello from Scotland. Oh boy, messages. Hello from Barbados. That's how you say it. Wow, never been there. Barbados. That's awesome. Colorado wheat season. Nice. How long will it take to grow this crop that we're planting right here? Will probably be sometime in September. Would be my guess. Harvest in September. If all goes to plan, hard to say that'll happen, but that's the plan. So we'll see if we get there. Bob is seeding. Yes, Dad is in the other air drill just over the hill, right over here. He's not far away, and he's in a nice field over there. Been going at it.
So should we do the AccuTurn?
Yeah. So leg arms just enabled AccuTurn. If you guys don't know what AccuTurn is, basically the tractor is going to start turning itself, so we won't have to do any more steering at this point.
When I get close enough, I choose when I want to turn, like right now, button, and it just automatically turns.
So the tractor is now turning itself on its own. And it's going to skip a swath, because that's how we have it set up at the moment. And it's going to find the next AB line. He doesn't have to lift the drill out of the ground. There we go, and then it straightens out. Completely hands off from leg arms. Then turned around. And then when we come through the other pass, we'll catch all those opposite passes, or the every other pass, the evens and the odds. So that's pretty cool. This AccuTurn is something that you would never expect to see
and a 1979 tractor that's 40 some years old. This is pretty amazing. Thanks to Case IH for bringing this in here.
So if we had a electronic valve body for the hydraulics, I know you could integrate that into the Pro 700, and it would be able to lift the toolbar out of the ground and put it back down on the ground if you really wanted to. It's capable of doing it. It's just we have manual levers, so you literally have to manually turn them.
Yeah.
But if we change the valve body on it, you can make it so that way you basically sit there and it'll just pick it up, turn, set it down, away you go.
Farm itself. It's pretty awesome. Yeah. So definitely shout out to Case International, yeah. Case IH for making this happen. This has definitely been their pretty cool treat. So yeah.
I think this is like the best thing they've ever done. Right?
Probably
the best thing they've ever done. Like, out of all the stuff they've done, this is probably the cat's meow.
And this is the same system that's running in, well, I guess some of the new equipment line coming out of Case IH. Like, the new Steigers and the Magnums have the new Pro 1200. But this...
Does the Patriots have the 1200 or is it still the 700?
I don't think they do yet. So the combines, the sprayers, as well as a couple other items, I believe, are still running the Pro 700s, which that is right there.
Okay, we're going to go through a dip.
Yeah, there's another wall.
So I'm going to downshift.
I can't see it. There we go.
Oh, there you go.
So he just downshifted to go through that thing. As you can see. There we go. Nice washout. We never had washouts in this field until... we had a really, really strong rain or flash runoff in the spring, and it cut a lot of trenches in some of our fields. And we've been slowly going through with the field grader or motor grader and bring the sides back in and farming over it. But we haven't gotten to this field yet, unfortunately. So we're getting there. We're getting there. Cotton 765. Finished plant 2020 last night. Spraying tomorrow.
Nice.
It doesn't end, does it? Good job. That's awesome. Congratulations on finishing that. That's a good feeling to be done. We're looking forward to being done today. I've still got about 1,200 acres of spray of chem fallow, and I got 1,000 or 1,100 acres of spray of chickpeas. And so, then we'll be done.
So what do you think has been the highlight of all the spraying that you've been doing? Like, what's the most beneficial thing to help you out this year? I mean, there's a lot of things like... treble system in it, or
auto steer. Yeah, I mean mapping, guidance and mapping, definitely. But yeah, that'd be the most important part. I don't know. Big root's pretty awesome. It's gotten a lot of work done. Being able to go 50 miles an hour back and forth through your water supply, that helps.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's a lot of things. I mean, it's been good. I've been knocking out the acres for sure. I've got about. Almost 80 some hundred acres sprayed so far. So that's in about 3 weeks, but that's not going every day. It's like every couple days. And I don't know how many acres you have on this thing since you started.
Let's see.
I'll flip it over.
So far, I've done, if that's correct, 3,377 with this one.
Okay.
Dad seeded a lot more, of course, because we've been getting tied off doing other stuff too.
So. Yeah, so his tractor's definitely seeded more.
Yeah, a lot more. As far as like, probably for me, the best things for running this was having the Pro 700 run the auto steer, and then also have a new harness for the cart, so that way we can talk back and forth. It has been so much better than using the old flex coil version that you just had a lot of problems with. The blockage system has saved up my butt tremendously in the chickpeas lately, and a lot of block runs, but for the most part, it's been pretty good, just chaotic.
Yeah.
There's a lot going on, and every little bit we get pulled away, and we got to go do something else, and then you come back, and you jump in a tractor, and then something happens, and run off, and go fix it, go do something, and a lot behind the scenes, but we make it happen.
It's pretty cool. Good. Yeah, we've got Wagner, or Wags.
Yeah, Wiggles. I call him Wiggles.
Brad's our temporary hired hand, and he's out rolling right now with the chickpeas that we planted the last couple days, which we started on Thursday. so.
I bet you anything he's not going to watch this, so you can say anything you want about Wiggles.
Yeah, we won't. Yeah, he's not going to watch this. You guys can talk about Wiggles all you want. How many acres do we farm? It's around 10,000 on this farm. Been at that for a couple years, so. Let's see.
So you wanna
do another crop growth time lapse. I've thought about it. Do another AccuTurn?
Yeah, I'm going to do another AccuTurn.
So he's got to get it, the system to know when he wants it to turn each time. So he's setting up the south AccuTurn. So he'll tell it here to start turning. There's a beautiful Toyota. We'll see if Leg Arms runs into it. I guess I can't blame him because it's a tractor steering itself. That's my very used wheels there.
Oh, he did a pretty good job. Yeah.
Just a little bit of stepping on the paint.
Didn't take out my pickup. Nice. Toyotas can't die, though. They run forever.
Yeah. Top Gear proved that.
Yeah. Doesn't necessarily mean I'm like a huge Toyota fan, but those particular pickups are pretty tough. Where did Wiggles get his name? I think he named him that.
One day, I meant to say Wags, and I said Wiggles, and then I'm like, that's a good name. I'm going to call him Wiggles.
Wagner is his last name, so a lot of his... He was in the Air Force, I think. I think it was the Air Force, yeah, for a lot of years. And so in his time there, everyone called him Wags, I think was his name. So, but it just got changed to Wiggles. That's okay. He's got thick skin and a nice beard. And he's an excellent rattlesnake catcher.
And he makes some fantastic rattlesnake. I don't know what you call them.
Fried rattlesnake?
Yeah, you put them in a batter and you fry them and then...
probably like gator. Cook gators.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah, he loves catching rattlesnakes. Yeah, he's pretty good at it. And the rattlesnake is good eating.
He's got a tremendous amount of rattlesnake skins. And eventually he's going to make like belts or like on cowboy hats, the strip that goes around, or I don't know, probably a Tarzan suit with like rattlesnake skin or something like that. I don't know. You never know what he's going to do.
Be pretty awesome. And let's see. Cotton did that. Thanks to 20. What are we at now? Big Mac 39. Oh, Big Mac sounds good.
You hungry?
I am a little hungry. Not that our wives aren't making good food, but I'm looking forward to a little bit of a, maybe, I guess you could say vacation, getting out of the town, you know, get off the farm for a bit, eat some fast food. Yeah. Anyways, Big Mac 39, $10. If you could pick one keep on your farm, would you prefer an 8250 or the quad track with the grain cart? That's a good question. Man.
Oh, wow. You really... Yeah, that's a tough question. A bit of both, can I do that?
Yeah,
I'm
kind of leaning towards the quad track, but 8250 is pretty nice.
I think I'd go. Well, does it have to be a quad track or can it be like a wheel?
He said quad track, so you probably have to do quad track.
Yeah, I think I'd do a quad track.
Charlie B. 100 underlined twice. 100 underlined twice. What does that mean? 100 underlined twice. I'm not sure what that is. No Fear Ford. 15. Hi from Kentucky. Seen y'all in Louisville a while back. Keep up the great videos. Hey, that's awesome. Glad we met. That's cool. We'll be back there this year. Well, no, wait. Yes, the National Farm Machinery Show is always in Louisville. We'll be there. Yep. Definitely. Boheim. Yeah.
Yep.
Bohemian Ford, $5. Put this money in the lake house, and how is it coming? You should run the SCVs for leg arms. Lake house.
Yeah, I didn't see the whole piece, so you can just.
It's been on hold for a little while. Farming picked up. I haven't been over there in about a month and a half. The inside's about 85% done. We have a lot still we got to do. We want to get this done. If we can get farming done, we will hopefully get over there. I got new railing installed. I got a guy coming to do a bunch of landscaping and work on the water side, get a dock installed, rip the old dock out, the old boathouse out, the old pump house out. I got a new septic field that's got to go in because the old one turned out it wasn't sufficient enough. That's going to be expensive. So there's a lot of stuff happening at the lake house. Thank you for the money. It's going to be a beautiful place when it's done. And we We got a couple bookings already. It is open, guys. So if you wanted to stay in just outside of Kalispell, Montana, on a lake, I do have a lake house that is up on VRBO, Airbnb, and Mikasa. So there's a couple bookings, but we're not quite there yet. I gotta get a hot tub installed, so we're gonna spend some time there. Hopefully in about a week, there.
I'll have to go to the end and stop and unplug it.
Oh, got another plug?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see, what else do we have here? Mike Pierce, 28, thanks for your hard work, and for Harry Benjamin, rest in peace. Harry didn't die, did he?
What? I hope not.
I hope that's not true. I didn't hear of this.
I didn't hear
of it. I knew he wasn't doing very well, but... Okay, well, I'm gonna have to look into that. I hope that's not true. That would be really sad. Grant Jordan. I think we'd know if the news gets around here pretty quick. $5. Did you guys see any comment asking for some footage of leg arms in the 600/50? Yeah, actually, we've seen quite a few. There's a lot of footage, guys. There's footage of this tractor. We just hasn't gotten into a lot of videos yet. It's coming. Don't worry. There will be some. It was hard this year. I was just a lot of spraying and wasn't out in the field with these guys as much. So, but we got some good footage. I got some stellar drone footage last night. So hopefully, it'll make a good video soon. But we're backlogged about a week. So videos are going to keep coming. There's a lot of stuff. It's just behind a little bit from what you see now. Do I edit my own videos? Used to. Once in a while I do, but no. Most of my editing, if not nearly all of it, is done by Modi Services. There's some friends of mine, and they've been editing for just about a year now. So yeah, all my videos, if you guys are wondering, there's a couple different guys that do it. They're all part of Modi, but they typically have one primary guy that does it, but when he's unable, another guy step up and they do it. So yeah, it's really nice having them edit. There's no way this channel would even happen if I had to edit. I couldn't physically do it to keep up. Life's so crazy, it's hard to keep up even right now. So yeah, but it's really nice. I'm really, really blessed to be able to have editors. Should we go outside and see him clean that thing? Let's go. And yes, there will be a lake house update video. How's our cell service here? I think it's good. I actually have quite a bit of footage already, but I was gonna make the reveal video of the place when I go up there next. I just haven't been there in like 2 months. So those chickpeas are big. They're like little ball bearings or marbles, and they're not perfectly round, and the cage inside these things. So he has to go in every now and then.
I really can't tell sometimes.
These are the press wheels. This drill is old. This drill is well old. We've had this thing for a long time. Yeah, it's 20 years old as of this year. This tool right here. 2004. But this here is, 20 years old. Built in 2000, and it shows it. We've rebuilt a lot of it, but we're due for a new drill. We're hoping this year maybe these chickpeas will do well, and we'll make some money. And then we can update maybe one, if not two of these. That would be amazing if we could. They're good drills. It's just at a certain point, you just get so wore that stuff just breaks all the time. You can see all these red shanks. That's because we've been robbing them off an older drill of ours that we use as a spare. It's a parts drill that we just keep scavenging off of. But I don't know. There's a lot better technology now, and this thing, it's seen better days. How we are these days, we kind of need machinery that's going to work when you need it to work. Not that new doesn't all the time. Sometimes new has problems, but they're showing their age. So I'm like, this thing got a new outlook on life. Minus the walk up here. Here's our fan. That's taking the air and it's blowing it down into here. And then the tanks have meters right here behind this thing. And it meters the product down in the tube. Down that, which go out into all that. If that makes sense. Okay. The back's kind of hurting these days. All right.
I had Old Glory on here earlier. We had to take it down, but yeah, that's up for right now. I figured we'll leave the POW MIA flag up for now. But yeah, is it lagging a little bit, guys? Apologize for that. We're kind of in a low spot. Service might be hit and miss. Leg Arms is getting something out of the field over here. There's like a blanket or something hiding out in the field. There he goes. I don't know what that is. Part of a couch cushion, maybe? Okay, oops. Why is it zooming out? All right, well, let's get down. Let's get inside the tractor. We'll get going here. Get out of that wind. Oh, there. Okay. All right. Where were we? Let's move along. Hopefully the signal picks up. All right. Mike Pierce, $20. He was a really good friend of the family, and my grandparents told a couple days that it would shock me, but thank you guys for all you do. Wow, Mike. I really hope that's not true, but if that's the case, I did not hear about that. That's really sad. Yeah, I'm gonna find out right after this live stream. Cause Harry is a one of a kind. Not many guys like him. And I actually have some footage of him that I've never shared, and I've been trying to find a place to do that. So maybe I'll, I don't know. Hope that's not true. Yes, Harry passed away. Wow, that's really sad. That's too bad. Yeah, I was kind of hoping to interview him sometime, talk about some of the tractors that he's had and the toys that he made, but yeah. Passed away on May 11th, I think. What day is it? 13th? 16th. Wow, that's been a few days. I can't believe I didn't hear about that. I guess that's what I get for being out on the farm. Wow, okay. Well, Harry Benjamin. Okay, guys, I know we're talking about Harry here. It's kind of a shock to me to hear that he passed away, because he's basically like everybody's favorite grandpa. And, you can. He's an old farmer, or I guess retired farmer, who I grew up with his grandsons. His family has been in this area for as long as my family has. And he's done some amazing things. He would build just about anything he could. That guy could build anything. And he's the one that set up the...
Whoa, there's a whole
a big bump.
Hello.
He set up the carousel in Shelby, Montana. Bought an old carousel from a fair that's from like 1920 something, and out of his own money, and it's set up in Shelby. It's pretty cool. So yeah, that's a sad deal. I've had Harry in a couple videos. People say, yeah, he passed away the 11th, I guess.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's what everyone's saying.
Oh my.
That's too bad.
Oh, so, wow, I didn't know that.
Yeah, well, thank you for the donation, and that's thanks for the news. Oh, look at that. Yeah, Grant Jordan say it's $2. Harry Benjamin passed away on May 11th, 2020. I knew he wasn't doing well. That's too bad. Well, I'll have to find out when the funeral services, if when they are, if they're gonna have them. I don't know. I think you can stab them out in Montana with the COVID thing. So, that's really sad.
One of the news things about Harry is he had a huge passion for blessing young kids. He would just make toys. He would just, he loved playing with kids, and he's a hard worker.
The guy was about as genuine as you can get. His hands, you looked at his hands, his fingers were all not bent and crooked, but you could tell those hands had worked so hard over the years. They were super thick, huge. And I mean, just the amount of work that he's done throughout his life. That guy never stopped.
There was a time that we were in Great Falls picking up some steel from our local steel place, and Harry was in front of us, and he was getting some steel. He left with his pickup. We talked to him for a little bit, and then he left. Well, then the guy working at that place, he's like, I've never seen somebody buy as much steel as that guy has. He's in here almost every week, is what he said. That guy was amazing with metal.
Always fabricating, always building stuff. Pretty cool guy. Another bump. Hang it on.
This field's got a couple washouts right in this back end down here. We gotta get near the grader, clean that up. So, yes, definitely rest in peace, Harry. That's too bad. How is the brood? The brood is great. The brood's sitting in the yard right now waiting to be filled up. A little windy right now, so I'm holding off spraying. That's why I'm in here. But as soon as the wind dies down, I'm back out again. I got about 2,000 acres, 2,500 acres left to spray. Hopefully have that done here soon. So, yeah, that'd be definitely something we need to do. Get that done. Beat Millennial Farmer to 1 million subscribers, Robert Neal. I don't know if we can. That guy is a machine. He's an animal. He's got something going on, and it's working really good. It's awesome. So
you gotta admit, the guy is a pretty awesome guy. Yeah. Like, he's fun to be around.
Yeah, he's a riot.
He's smart.
We'll keep pushing on. Our channel's growing pretty steady, and it's good to get where it's at. And we'll keep moving. And we're crazy thrilled to be where we're at right now. I still can't even believe we're getting close to 400,000 subscribers. That's unreal. So yeah, really happy about that. You guys are awesome for being a part of that. It's exciting. I can't wait for Farm Channel to hit 1 million subscribers. It's gonna happen. And I think it's gonna be one of those guys. So, but we'll be there eventually. I really want to get 1 million subscribers someday.
So the question is for you guys, is Cole the Corn Star, Millennial Farmer, or us, there we go, who's gonna hit the 1 million first? Probably Zach.
I think Zach's got a good run at it. He's got the highest lead. Cole's got
Cole's
a good run going.
Cole's got a pretty good run, too.
Yeah. You never know, though. There's other channels out there. There's a lot of farm channels. There's a lot of guys that are growing fast. Some can come out of nowhere and take off. It's really hard to say. It really is. Really hard to say. You know, it could change. How farms work, it's pretty big. I mean, you just don't know these channels, how fast they'll pick up steam and go. YouTube's a weird thing. Really weird thing. Hard to predict, hard to understand, hard to figure out, but everyone's always trying to evolve their channel to find the best way to keep growing. It's kind of annoying, actually, that we have to do that, but it's just kind of how it works. So, yeah. But Brian's farm videos, yep, you never know, he might. There's
Harmless
a lot of them.
Harmless Farmer, maybe.
Harmless Farmer could get there. I mean,
By the way, did you hear that Harmless Farmer had his last chemo treatment?
Yeah, I did.
That's awesome.
Good for him. Good for Andy. Yeah. That's awesome.
If you guys haven't seen it, you gotta check out Harmless Farmer. He's an awesome guy. He's literally does things that we could never imagine doing with no arms.
Yeah.
Like, there's no way I could do what he does.
Yeah, he's pretty awesome. Andy's a good guy. Was that Larson Farms? Yeah,
sweet, yeah.
He's growing quite a bit. Yep. No, there's a number of them. And that's just it. Like, it's not a race. I mean, you kind of want some competition because it helps drive you to do harder. If you're the only one out there, what motivates you to push yourself even more?
It's more of battering back and forth. It's kind of a razzing. It's fun.
Yeah.
The different channels.
It's good, but there's a lot that goes to it, though. A lot of things that you don't realize unless you're the one doing it. A lot of effort put into it, and you want to see how you see rewards as growth. And so, yeah. But anyways, but I appreciate all the support from you guys. You guys are awesome. Grant and Jordan are my parents. Call me Aiden. Oh, okay. Thank you, Aiden. Thank you, Aiden. Well, I appreciate Aiden. Sean Ward, 50. Wow. Hippo character wearing cool sunglasses comes out of treasure chest. I was like, oh, my God, that's doing that again. Okay. I know what that is. I got to stop doing that. So the app I'm using, I'm sorry about this. So YouTube now allows you to buy these stickers, which he just did. Thank you for that, by the way. I didn't know this till recently. My app that I'm using to do these live streams with doesn't show that character, that sticker that you guys all saw. Instead, it spells out to me what it is in words. So I just read what it is. So when it tells me, he put a picture of a hippo character wearing cool sunglasses, comes out of treasure chest, tossing coins around him. But to me, it just says that. My wife.
I hope it just keeps saying those things and gets repeated, because that's hilarious.
It's hilarious. I read it. I'm like, what is this person talking about? And then I realized, oh, see, if I would use the YouTube app, I would actually see that. So, but thank you for that. So, if you guys want to have me read,
please send a couple more of those.
They're pretty funny. I know. David Honor, I'm subscribed to you, but not Millennial Farmer. Oh, poor guy.
Don't tell Zach that.
Yeah.
He might
have hurt his feelings.
Yeah.
It's okay. You can subscribe to everybody. It's all good. It's one thing cool about subscribing is you can subscribe, and if you don't like the person, you can just unclick the bell and not see their stuff but still be subscribed. So support all the ag community. Unless there's somebody you really don't like. Like one of these. Then you don't have to. Zach Johnson's first, Welker's a second, Cole Cornstar third. That could happen. That might be it. That's where it is right now, actually. But
yeah, he is third place, isn't he? Cole.
I think so. Yeah. I mean, the thing is, there's other channels around the world that are big, way bigger than us that are considered farm channels.
But
so
in the U.S., that's the order, right?
Yeah, North America. In North America, that was probably how it is on YouTube. Let's see here. Face mask or no face mask? Well, right now, out on the farm, no face mask.
I just ran out of the third tank.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay. He's just switched over.
Yeah.
So we just ran out of the last of the rear tank in there. So now he has the front tank left. So he switched over to that. We're definitely going to have probably enough to finish this.
I'll have enough to finish this, and then we'll have to go to another field probably. Unless Dad needs more to finish, but
he might.
There's still some in the truck, isn't there?
There's a little bit. It's not much. Okay. Enough to do maybe like 10 acres.
Oh, we're going to get close.
Yeah. Yep, so, no. What are we planting? We're planting garbanzo beans or chickpeas, whichever one you want to call it. Gage Swenson, hey Gage, you guys finished up a couple days ago. They're all done. They also have some nice machinery to get her done. You guys did a good job getting that all in. That's awesome, Gage. Let's see here. Flex one-time leg arms.
I haven't been in the gym since this whole COVID-19 started. Because they shut the gym down.
Yeah, they locked it. They put chains over the doors. What do you let you in?
I've just been working.
Farming's gotten... It's tough to go to the gym in these kind of season. Long days. Last thing you want to do is spend your day in the gym when you want to be home with your family. I haven't been in the gym in a long time. It's really sad. I used to be the biggest gym nut. Spent so many hours in there working out over the years. And I haven't been in a long time. And it's honestly really... really hard to see yourself kind of just not fade away, it's not like that, but just lose all those gains that you had over the years. So someday we'd like to get back there. Should build our own gym. Honestly, for the amount of money we've spent going to the gym over the years, we could have bought our own equipment and probably had our building put up. I don't. But the thing with that, I don't know, I've been told this and it is kind of true. If you have your own gym, you hardly ever use it. But if you have a gym membership, you have more motivation to go to the gym, so I don't know. What state? Echo, let's see, we're in Montana right now. Leg arms, nice beard.
What about, I could pull an Ace Ventura, you know, he's got like, hang on a second, hang on. Hang on, hey. Almost Ace Ventura.
Yeah, he's getting a little bit of hair there.
Yeah.
Should get Sarah to cut that.
I think about Taryn.
Oh yeah, Taryn will cut your hair.
She's gonna cut in hair.
I bet she is. She'd probably be really good at that. How's farm life? Farm life's really good. It's very stressful right now just because a lot's going on. Honestly, YouTube is probably the biggest reason for stress as far as my end of the thing, but overall it's been really good. It's been really good. Quarantine haircut for like, yeah, that's exactly what it is. So yeah. Let's see what else.
I'm gonna donate my hair to like, what is it, Goldie? Locks
for Love or
something? Locks of Love, yeah.
Yeah, Locks of Love.
Yeah, for baby kittens.
For baby kittens, that makes sense. Yeah. Shear leg arms. I don't know if we have a sheep shear. We can find one somewhere. I actually just bought a straight razor, My wife has a razor blade or whatever you call it set up for her grandpa. She's pretty sure it's her grandpa's. You buy these like straight razors, these little inserts, and you put them inside of it. Man, that thing shaves nice. It's pretty awesome. And the inserts are super cheap. But I did cut myself a couple times around my Adam's apple here, so I gotta get better at that. But yeah, pretty awesome. It's much better than those like five-bladed Mach 20 razors, whatever those are. Yeah, a lot better. Do we want the Big Bud 747? Absolutely we do, but it's okay. It's owned by a great family. They've owned it for a number of years. They put a lot of work into it. They deserve to have that tractor. So
I'm very glad that they're able to get that tractor.
Yeah,
William. And it's supposedly going to come back to Montana where it was built. So
Williamson Brothers own it, and it's pretty awesome. They're getting that thing running again. So my thigh hair is 1,000 times worse than leg arms. You can really get that bad? I mean, look at that.
Come on. Do you have the receding and like the ridiculous amount of white and gray?
I'm getting it too.
Yeah.
The gray is coming back for me too. Yeah, that's okay. That's the joy of aging. Jason Hendricks, $3. Okay, here we go. Here's another one of those sticker things. Pair character punching the air with fist and bump written on his knuckles. Yes. I can't believe that he spells it out. That's hilarious. Thank you for the pair character punching the air with fist and bump written on his knuckles.
That's awesome.
That's great. I'm so glad I know what that is now. That's actually honestly more fun reading the description of those stickers than it is actually probably seeing it. David Honor, hands doing a fist bump. There's another one. Is that, oh, fist bump, that's this. Yeah, you want this. But this doesn't work very good. I gotta fix that thing. It doesn't throw enough air into that horn and it doesn't honk.
Well, you had the right valve and then it just got rocked.
Yeah, just broke. Unfortunately, it was really cheap plastic, so I gotta get a new valve for that thing. Awesome Goofball Dollar, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Tofstra Cubbing, 2007? 279, how's the farm and family? Family's doing really good. They're getting a little bit of cabin fever, ready to get out of town, go to the lake house, hang out. I don't know, I'm ready to spend some time with the kids, honestly.
Yeah.
I saw an old video of my daughter that I made 2 years ago of her, and I don't know. Makes you want to spend time with them really bad. So, yeah, we'll get out of the tractors and get some family time going. Maybe, like, take a sabbatical, if that's the word. I'd like to honestly, like, disappear for 2 weeks, but we're getting backlogged on YouTube videos, so maybe I'll be able to do that. That'd be pretty awesome. But, yeah, definitely doing great. Family's doing really good overall. Yep, been doing really well. How's the Minneapolis Moline? It's doing really good. It runs awesome. It needs a couple things done to it, but overall, it's...
And it's got like a adopted brother too, right?
Yeah, it does. It has a friend that we haven't shown you guys yet.
We're gonna call it a friend.
Yeah, a friend.
Yeah, that's, I like that.
That may or may not be alive. We haven't determined that yet. So, yeah.
Keyword guys, wink, wink.
Yeah. Things are happening. That's why I have glasses on. Fred Young says that's Cornstar haircut.
Is it?
I don't know. Yeah, Cole's hair is pretty messy.
I guess I haven't really noticed.
His hair is pretty messy.
Doesn't he usually have a beanie on?
Yeah, he usually wears a beanie, but Viper glasses. Jimmy Beckett, $2. Pair character turning around and waving his hand, saying, "Hey, you," while lowering his glasses. It's funny because I can totally envision what that looks like. I can't see it, but I can totally tell. Pair character turning around, waving his hand, saying, "Hey, you," while lowering his glasses.
So they don't see the description of what it is. They just see
a picture. Yeah, they see the emoji sticker of it.
Yeah, that's funny.
I see the description of it. They see the sticker. Toby Collins, $2. Love the video. Shout out from New Zealand. That's awesome. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. That's great. Oh, yeah. Nice shirt. I know. I like this shirt. It's a great shirt. Really nice shirt. Like, I almost feel bad wearing it as a work shirt, but then I realized I got a bunch of these, and, well, I could just get a bunch more, so they work good as shirts. I like showing them off. How old was I when I was first driving a tractor? Well, I first started harvesting around 9, 10 years old, so that was in a combine, but as far as driving a tractor, probably around then, too, I bet. I was probably in the combine first, actually. We had a Mini U, and I was 15, 47 years ago. Great memories. That's awesome. They're pretty cool tractors. They're cool. We've had that one for a while, and we need to fix its brother up. It's got another one. Gage, how's the chickpeas going? They're going great. Going in the ground. We're on the last little bit, Gage. I don't know if you saw, but we are literally on the last field. It's hard to say if we finish this one before my dad. My dad's the other one, but I think he's got a few more acres done than we do. We'll see how it goes. But
we won't fill up two drills. It will probably fill him up first,
Yeah.
Because he's going to need seed right away.
Yeah.
So this one will probably finish, and then he'll finish the rest of it, I'm guessing.
We also are gauge. I don't know if you saw this, but we're running AccuTurn on here. So this Pro 700 set up with this tractor, so it'll turn itself. But you don't have to tell it to turn. It'll do it on itself. Oh, yeah, you got the auto button.
I've never done that.
Auto. There we go. All right.
You better do it.
No, it's going. Lead it. It's going. It's going. It'll turn. Just wait. There it goes. So auto, it'll do it itself. You don't have to tell it to. Yeah. You have to initially set the boundaries that you want it to turn at, and then you just switch it to auto, and now it'll always turn at those points from here on out.
I didn't know that.
So yeah, now there's completely hands off. Yeah, you don't have to the button. You can still say turn now if you want. Turn it early.
See, I'm not very techy, so what I like to do is if it works, I just want to just get things done. I don't try to like keep pushing buttons and then get myself in a pickle, because usually I'm not very good at pushing buttons, so I didn't know that. Thanks, Nick.
When we get to the end of the field, I'll show you guys. It'll alert us in a second. Not a second. It'll alert us when we get to the end of the field about 6 seconds before it turns, saying, hey, I'm about to turn the tractor. Are you ready for this? And then we can say no, or you can just wait and it'll start turning. And then the tractor turns around by itself. That's pretty sweet, isn't it?
That is very sweet.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool. Oh, there's another one. Moontan Applesauce. That's a hilarious name. $2. Lemon character running, then kneeling on the floor, his arms wide open, and a slice of lemon appearing behind him. What? Lemon character running, then kneeling on the floor, his arms wide open, and then a slice of lemon appearing behind him.
So is it a description on the picture that's already set up?
Well, where's your phone at? Pull your phone up. Go log on to the stream with your phone in the app, and then you'll be able to see what we're talking about here. That's hilarious. Oh man. I'm like trying to figure that out. I don't even get how that works. There's a sticker. What's that right there? Is that the sticker? No. It's probably in the feed somewhere.
Well, you need to go like
all the way down to the bottom. Oh wait, is that something right there? No.
I don't know.
Maybe it'll pop up on there.
Well, it looks like a box of rice.
We'll see, yeah. We'll see when the next one comes up. He's got his phone up now, so we'll be able to see what it looks like.
You guys can watch yourself, too.
Yeah.
That's it.
Pretty sweet.
It's a little delayed. Okay, here's a sticker.
Oh, there it is. Where is it? Okay, that's like a hippo running. Mark Stanley. Is that new? Oh, he just pasted it. Okay, so. All right, I see it. All right. Hippo character runs at high speeds, his legs forming a ball-like blur. It does.
That's very accurate.
Thank you for the $5. That's pretty funny. Hippo character running really fast. His legs making ball-like character. That's good. Oh, another one. Okay. I should read it first, then I'll see it. Montune Applesauce, $2. Hair character putting his hands in front of his mouth while blushing. Is he?
Yeah, he was.
Oh, he is. One hand, not hands. Oh, wait, his hand. I read it wrong. His hand. That is right. That's so good. This guy gave $20 for your haircut, Scott. Wife says you need one.
Who?
His wife says you need a haircut, so he gave $20.
Oh, man.
I don't think I have $20 in my wallet.
I'm going to get a perm.
Do I have $20 in my wallet?
Do I need a perm? I like a perm. Actually, I've never gotten a perm before.
I pull my wallet out of my pants, and a bunch of chickpeas come out, too. That's when you know you've been planting.
What about all that inoculant? Did any of that come out?
That's in my lungs right now.
Yeah, it's still
in my lungs. And on my pants and everything. Inoculant is all over the place. Thank you for the $20. I'll pass it along to Leg Arms. Get my cut. He likes some of this.
You actually earned it, Nick. You do so much.
This guy says, I can't hear. Well, if you guys can't hear me, let me know. I can turn the volume up. If it's I've got it set where I think it's right, but if it's a little quiet, I can always crank the volume. I'm just worried about the
noise.
Just
curious, do you guys hear a lot of like humming from the tractor, or is it just... Does it sound like static? I'm just curious what it sounds like.
Well, I'll show you what my microphone looks like.
I guess I could turn this up.
Here.
Listen.
This is my...
Turn this up.
There. There's the mic.
It's got a little bit of a drone. That's not too bad. Okay.
There.
Yeah. They can hear us pretty good.
Can they?
Yeah.
Good. Yeah, if I use the cell phone microphone, it's really loud and obnoxious. It picks up all the background noise of the tractor, and so, yeah, this is better.
I
like this one better.
I'm worried about that thing right there in the field.
We need to dig that out. Is there...
I don't even know what it is.
I think it's an old gas well, honestly. There's something in the field here, and we've hit it with a combine. Absolutely destroyed a reel on a combine.
Remember,
yeah.
When?
Yeah, a long time ago. Dad ran into it at night. It was a night.
I didn't know about this.
And bent the reel all up.
I was wondering why I was bent over. Like, I never heard about this.
Yeah, he ran into it in the middle of the night. I think the wind was blowing in the chaff. He couldn't see. And it went right into it. Yeah.
Those weren't with the 8230s, was it?
No, that might have been 2188s.
Oh, so was that long ago?
Yeah, it's been a while.
Wow.
Been a long time. Remy Colonel, $10. Hey, how are you guys doing? Finally able to see a stream of planting. How many acres are you planting this year? Okay. How much of each crop? Loving the video. Stay reasonable. Stay safe. Okay, real quick. AccuTurn's turning. Oh, crap. Turn. Yeah, that's what it shows. It's going to turn the tractor in. 1 second. Okay, now it's turning. Tractor is turning by itself. I'm trying to find the best way to capture this by standing in here. So it goes straight for a little bit, then it starts turning again. So now we are turning back to line up.
A little tiny strip.
Nah, just seed over it. That's not bad. Or is it going to miss it?
No, it's going to leave a little strip.
Oh, is it?
A little tiny strip.
Don't worry about it. We'll just have to just leave it. It's not worth.
Which is fine, because it'll just, show the difference.
That's how it came out. Okay, back to your question. Let's see here. Your question is, how are you guys doing? Well, we're doing great. I think so. I'll answer for Legarms. He's doing awesome.
Yep, fantastic. Wait, what?
Finally able to catch a stream. Good, that's good. How many acres are you planting this year? About 7,400. Maybe actually a little more than that.
It's over 9,000.
Yeah, 7,500 I think now. We had a little more peas than we were expecting, and we were kind of stretching these chickpeas out a little bit further too. So about 7,500. How much are you planting of each crop? Well, we got about 5,000 of spring wheat, about 1,400 of yellow peas, and about 1,100 of chickpeas, or garbanzo beans, if you want to call it that. Thank you for the donation, by the way. Aaron Griffith, $5. Montana Highline native turned airline pilot. Love the videos. Looking forward to seeing the Wagner. Used to run a WA-17. Nice.
That's awesome.
We used to have a WA-17 on this farm, I think. Pretty sure they did.
17?
We had a 14.
We had a 17, I believe.
That's really
that
cool.
That was right before the first bud, right?
Yeah, I think so. Aaron, I hope you're doing well with the whole airline thing right now. I can't even imagine what it's like to be in the airline industry. That is a tough industry. Very tough. Stuff like this. This is like the worst thing that could possibly happen to that. So hopefully you're still flying. I can only imagine. But thank you for the $5. I really appreciate it. Box VT, $20. Oh boy, it's a long one. Pear character, looking at himself in the mirror, says, "Thanks for being you," with hearts popping out of his eyes.
Sounds like he's got other problems going on.
That sounds like something that millennial farmer actor guy would do every day.
Wait, the actor or the
actor?
Sunman?
Not the actual farmer.
Oh, okay. Because there's a difference, right?
Yeah. Character looking at himself in the mirror saying, "Thanks for being you," while heart's popping out of his eyes.
Yeah, that's definitely the... Yeah. Yeah.
That's definitely a millennial farmer, for sure. Definitely. That could be a Brian Board or Brian Farman video, though. Brian Brown.
Yeah, that's true.
Thank you for the donation. Cedars, 25. Having fun. Thanks for the amazing content all year round. Thank you. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You.
There's a lot of stuff coming. It's just hard to say when it'll come, but it definitely is coming. Some cool things we got planned, some ideas. We've got stuff in the works. So, yeah. Dad's in the stream, says he. Nice. Trying to read your guys' comments, catching up on this stuff. Hello from Western Australia. You guys are going hard at it. You're about to enter your winter, right? I think so. I think your winter's about to enter. Tony Zillick, $10. Thanks, guys, for the great videos. How's Big Brew? Big Brew's doing really good. Hanging out in the yard. I gotta put those, everyone's asking about those wheels that we put on, and they broke off. Well, at least one side broke off, so we took the other side off so it didn't break off.
So I'll explain what I did wrong. Keyword, what I did wrong. Two things. These springs were really old, so it's possible that they just couldn't take quite that flexing. The other thing too is when I cut a hole in the center of the leaf spring and put a U-bolt and tighten it up, that was a weak spot for it to flex on. And I should have had a U-bolt going on the outside of it with another plate so it stops it from bending right where the U-bolt is. And I couldn't take that much of abuse. Nick? I didn't...
Sorry.
Did I throw you underneath the bus?
No.
Okay, good.
And so right now with the AccuTurn, I don't know if you've done it yet, because it's on auto, you got to hit the other arrow.
Well, so, no, I'm going to turn around and come back on this path.
Have you already hit that arrow?
I switched those before.
You did switch it.
I okay. turned it off so I can go back on
no,
this path.
No, just hit auto. Hit auto. Okay, now hit the other arrow. There.
What about this pass?
Oh,
I
yes.
I got to get that pass.
You're right, you're right. Yeah, you, that's right. You got to start it. You're right. Yep, you got to get the first one and then it'll do it.
Because I don't want to miss
yeah.
that one.
That's right. He's right. What am I talking about? I don't even know what I'm doing here. I'm not even a farmer. I need to get off this tractor. He threw you under the bus. Yes, he did. He's like that. Grant? Oh, actually, Aiden? Was that your name again? I remember. Do the buds have push starts or keys? This one has a key. We could put a push start if we wanted to, but yeah, they're keys. Keys on the ignition. This one's all actually on the ignition. The other one...
The big buds came with GM steering columns. So did the Steigers, actually.
I think so, yeah.
Most of the Steigers came with the GM steering column. So,
yeah.
Hey, that's something the Steiger and Bud had in common.
Yeah, same steering column.
Yeah.
Greetings from Newfoundland, Canada. Love the videos. Thank you. Thank you for the donation. Adam Wood, $5. Thank you, Adam. Thank you, Adam. Quickie's doing great, by the way. You're awesome. Zach C. Taylor, hey guys, how are you liking the 600 Big Bud? It's pretty nice. It's been really nice. There's a slight vibration. We haven't quite figured out what it is yet. There was a universal joint that was out of alignment that leg arms caught, and he got that fixed. But there's still a vibration down there that we don't like. There's a couple of things we still got to do to this tractor. It's been running awesome this year, but it's leaking a lot of oil out of the engine, unfortunately, and there's one hydraulic leak. And a lot of those leaks on the engine, there's not much you can do to fix them without taking the engine literally apart and then putting new gaskets in and putting it back together again. So,
I don't know.
We gotta decide what we're gonna do about that, but we hate leakiness. I hate leaky oil. It just gets all over everything, gets on your windows, gets on your paint.
Well,
not good.
Technically, we don't have to pull the engine out, but we do have to support the front of the engine, pull the oil pans off, and then there's a spacer plate that bolts to the bottom of the block, and that's got to come off, and then you got to change that whole entire gasket. So that's going to be a bit of a chore. So what it's doing is, it's not the oil pan, it's right above that spacer plate to the block, and it's leaking all the way around on it, and the bolts are inside the oil pan. It's possible we can take the oil pan off and tighten them up and you'll be okay, but chances are when it's leaking, you're going to have to do something about
it. Can we just take the oil pan off, just clean it up real good in there, then write stuff around the inside. Put sealer on the inside. Just an idea.
I don't want to say no.
As long as it doesn't get in the oil.
At the same time too, we better do it right.
It'd probably break off and get in your oil system and make a mess. Yeah, we gotta do it.
I like
that,
but.
Dragon of Death, I think that's what that says. $10. I drive a truck, enjoy watching the content when I'm not driving. Awesome, thank you. I'm sure you've never driven a truck and watched at the same time, right? Oh, thank you. Appreciate it. Oh boy, another one. Corey Larson, $50. Thank you.
Wow.
Hero character riding a firework rocket, disappearing away before bursting into the sky. What is up with these pair characters? Pair character. Riding a rocket, disappearing away before bursting into the sky.
It sounds like
that's awesome.
It sounds like a bedtime story you're gonna read your kids.
Yeah. Center 25. Your dad asked how much is left on the truck. Thought I'd let you know. Oh, well, why doesn't he just call us? Oh, he's saying in the chat there. There's probably about 10 or 15 bushels. Would you want to guess?
That.
Not even that much. I don't even know if it's that much.
Oh wow.
It's not a lot. There's not a lot left in the truck. It's probably, yeah. It's
and I'm
it's
just a little
slow.
Under 3/4 full.
Yeah, we're
on the front tank.
We'll have enough to finish this field with what's in this rig, and we'll probably have to go somewhere else. So, yeah. Thanks for the heads up about my dad. That's awesome. Jimmy Beckett, $2. Okay. Shiba Dog raises and lowers his index finger to get noticed. Thank you, okay. Shiba Dog.
Shiba Dog.
Is that? I think I know that dog.
Shiba Dog.
I can't believe they have to name those things.
So they've already pre-named them, and then that's what it shows up.
Well, it's
up
like an emoji, you know. It's like.
But when they make the emojis, do they have to come up with a saying?
They must. And this app that I'm using, for whatever reason, this just reads them to me. So, yeah, I don't know why. That's hilarious. Thank you. And Andre Seabrooks, $2. Thank you, Andre. You can post something there if you want. How dare you? I know. Index finger. Okay. Trying to keep up with everybody here. AJ's here. Thank you, AJ. AJ's a super fan. Been with us for a long time. He's pretty big on Farming Simulator and a couple other stuff, too. Dad says he'll run out soon. Well, I could, I'll tell you what, Dad. When we get to the end of the field here, I got a pickup nearby. I'll jump in that. I'll run over and I'll grab the truck, and we'll go top you off.
How much does he have left on that field?
How much do you think you have left, Dad? Need comment. Let us know.
Because if he empties out before me, then I might still got some. I could go over and finish him.
Yeah, Scott potentially could go finish over there too.
Because there's not that much in the truck, as it turns out.
Which cab is bigger, Big Bud or Quad Track? Actually, I think the Quad Track's a little bigger. This cab might be a little longer up at the top, but.
Well, it's 5 by 5 feet on the bottom.
It's a big square.
The top is probably 6 feet by 5 feet.
But there's really not a lot of room right here. I mean, the armrest here is bumping into the side of me. It's not terrible.
If we move the seat over a little bit, you'd have more. But yeah. We like to swivel and turn and watch what we're doing.
Yeah, yeah.
Speaking of turn, it's going to do itself, right?
Is it going to auto turn here in a second?
I sure hope so.
Did you, it's auto to the right.
Yeah.
It should. It hasn't alerted us yet. Oh, no. There it is.
Yay.
Okay, so.
6 seconds, 7 seconds, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hey.
Nice. There she goes. She's turning. Good tractor. And we're matching up with our line right here, as you guys can see.
So now I just gotta watch around that thing, right?
So it's gonna go straight, and it's gonna catch. Our windows are dirty. I'm gonna wash these windows down. I didn't think about that before.
It's okay, it gives it the real feeling.
So, AccuTurn just lined us up with the pass that we missed, because we're doing every other swath. Dad says he has about 30 minutes left.
Okay.
How is Nick? Nick is fantastic. Nick is fantastic. Nick is ready to be done with spring planning. Parent character doing a classic mic drop. Nice. That's awesome. I don't really want to drop my mic, otherwise it could break, so I'm not going to, but I get what that is. Thank you, parent character. Justin Groff, $10. Thank you, Justin. Oh, there's that thing, isn't it? There's an old gas well or something in the field there, and it's been waiting for someone to drive over and clobber it. I need to go and inspect it, see if there's a pipeline down in the ground or not.
Yeah. It's probably a big shutoff valve.
Turn it around. Try to hold this thing. There we go. There we go. So, as you guys, if you're new to the stream, we're on the last field. In the Big Bud, this is a 1979 Big Bud 52550 that's been upgraded to a 600 horsepower. It's got a lot of upgrades, including state-of-the-art guidance and auto steer system with a Pro 700 ISO bus system, so we can hook into all the new equipment, new drills, and run them well. And once Leg Arms gets set up here, he'll turn on the auto steer again, and then it'll take over for him. We don't have a foot switch yet. We got to get one in this tractor.
That would be nice.
So now it is tracking between the two rows that we seated earlier and perfectly seating. Oh yeah, look at this too. Look at this cross track error. So go to GPS on there. Oh, it's kind of high right now. It's going to settle down. There we go.
0.6, 0.5.
That cross track error, that's how much this tractor deviates left and right. That's something that's common with pretty much all auto steer, is it'll go left, right, left, right, left, right. And this thing is holding within like sub inch most of the time. That's like almost RTK. Yeah, you know, RTK is pretty much always sub inch.
But a downshift.
Okay, small bump here. Just a little bump. Okay.
By the way, we gotta talk about this thing here.
The shift pad?
Yeah.
I don't know if I have.
Let's see. Need to.
So we got a new shift pad too in this tractor.
Ooh, there we go.
So that there has been a setup by a guy who got tired of the old one that was in his big butt, so he had this made. I believe it's an Allison shift box, but he's had reprogrammed, and it's set up to handle the power shift or the twin disc transmission that's in this big bud. So we're trying it out for the first time, only been running it about 2 days, and it's been really nice. Really nice. This tractor shifts a lot easier, a lot smoother. Torque converter locks up better.
So one of the problems with the other shift box is, I mean, it was made in the 70s, I believe this one was in the 80s, and after a while, sometimes it'll lock up in there and it'll try to combine two clutch backs at the same time or same gears, and you'll tear up your transmission within, you know, no time, because this motor is just going to take it out.
And it's an easily $40,000 transmission.
Yes, and then it doesn't quite shift correctly, like it'll lock in earlier than it should or later than it should, or keep a clutch pack still locked in and try to lock in another one and transition, and it's just not very healthy. So with this new shift box, it's got parameters set correctly that will allow it so it doesn't make a mistake. You have a couple different settings on it. If you want to just run on the torque converter and not lock it up in a gear, you can. You can have a harder shift, you can have a softer shift, but it's a safer, like, insurance, and so far I've noticed a huge difference with it. Well worth it.
Yeah, it's been really nice. Where's the Wagner? It's on the farm, sitting in the back. It's waiting for a chance to get to the shop. We just haven't had that chance yet, but it will be eventually. Let's see here. I got 2,500 of you guys. Wow, a lot of you. We have a farm, but our big tractor is a 9270 case. That's a pretty good size tractor.
Now, does that have the 855 Cummins or the N14?
I think it's possibly an N14. Not sure on that. Do you answer people from Canada? Absolutely not. No way.
I mean, for one thing, we can smell their maple all the way over here. Yeah. It's so sweet. I can't take it.
So much maple syrup.
Just disgusting.
And hockey pucks.
Yeah, we keep throwing them back over the border. In fact, to just cram it in the cannon and just beep, and shoot them across.
Canadians are awesome. We're glad to have them as neighbors. There's not another country I'd rather have north of us than Canada. They're pretty awesome. So. he doesn't get that. This guy says, Scott, congratulations on your new baby.
Oh, thank you. I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be really exciting.
Well, I suppose I should jump out here and walk over to the pickup and get the truck for Dad.
Does he want to fill up, or does he want me to?
I think he does.
Feels like I'm getting too close, but I guess not.
Yeah, the auto steer's taking over again. It's turning
us. You want me to slow or downshift so you can go over?
You better stop. And then, yeah, it will mess up the AccuTurn if you stop, though, so you'll have to manually. I'm pretty sure it disengages it. And if I don't get back in time, by the time you finish the field,
I can slow down a little bit and you can...
Nah, just stop. That's fine. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna go grab the pickup. Oh, I'm getting a phone call. Dad's calling me and I'm live streaming. I can't pick that up. I don't know.
Probably telling
you call Scott. Problem. Call Scott right now, Dad. Talk to him. There.
Hey, what's up?
We'll see what he says.
I mean, you definitely, how much is left on that piece?
What we're trying to figure out right now, guys, is we're on the last little bit of seed. And so we're trying to see, does he need seed, or should leg arms get the seed? There's a little bit left in the truck, not much.
And I'm on five, so passes.
We don't want any weird fields where we just have like strips that aren't seeded.
I've got a little under three-quarter tank, so I have enough to fill, finish it all.
So that's what they're doing right now. And I just saw a big donation.
You might as well just seed it out.
Where and when did you get the 650? We got this tractor back in like 2007, I think.
Sounds good.
And it came from a farm over by Gage Swenson, actually, up by the Rocky Mountains, and we drove it home. But it needed a lot of work, and the first facelift, what do you say? Does he want that seat?
I'm going to finish it.
Does he want me to get the truck?
No.
Oh. Sorry, guys. Guess I'm standing here. Well, maybe I'll drive, and you can sit here. You get it going. Kind of getting tired of sitting in this awesome seat here. Bill Kleist. Oh, Bill, you did not have to do that. Bill K, it's got to be Bill Kleist.
Did he send you hate mail?
Yes.
Wow.
Here's a successful 20 planting and hoping for a bountiful harvest. Thanks for the work that you do. Go Welker Farms. If that's you, Bill. If it's not, Bill, that's awesome. Thank you. If that's the Bill that I know, Bill. You know, this is me just going to come stay at the lake house, I guess. Sixth generation farmer, South Dakota. Hey, have you guys harvested soybeans before? No, I have not. Have never harvested soybeans. They don't grow well in this country. I think it's our frost we get, the cold weather. So yeah, they can't really grow here. Just a random Bill in Philly. Oh, is it? Oh, you sound. I know a Bill Kleist with BK. So well, thank you, Bill. Appreciate it. Canada W. What are the donations for? They're just goodwill offerings, I guess you could say. Just people that you don't have to give us anything. But I appreciate those that do. It's just an option to support a channel. And it also is a way to get your comment noticed, because it alerts me when someone donates. So then I typically read the comment, because there's so many comments that go through the screen that I can't read them all. So it's kind of a way of like putting your comment front and center for me to read. Yeah, so it's a way to get attention. It's a way to support the channel. It's totally up to you, whatever you want to do. But Matthew McGee, $5. Hello, the Walker family. Cattle ranch from Louisiana saying hi. Oh, thank you. Really appreciate it. I suppose. You want to switch seats for a bit?
Sure.
I feel like sitting in that one. There we go. There's not a squat switch on the seat, so when I stand up and get off it, it doesn't turn off automatically. Ah, that's good on the back.
So if you need to use nature, you can walk outside the door. And
yeah.
Yeah.
There! What's up?
And you gotta turn the button so it turns the other way.
Okay. There we go. So here's our Pro 700. This is our Intelligent Ag iPad. So that's all of our runs. That's just telling us if there's any blockages back there. Really good system. Pro 700, I can see my GPS stuff here. AccuTurn is right here, it's set up. Map, let's take a look here. Let this thing populate. We haven't probably adjusted this in a while. That map is probably way off. Go back to cart. See what kind of rates we're doing. And there's acreage. So this tractor so far has got 3,400 acres on it, which makes sense. Let's go page one. There we go. There's a little bit of a dip coming up right here, so this thing will drive through it. This part isn't nearly as bad as it was down here. Down here, the ditch gets really bad.
I agree.
What's that?
You're gonna fill it.
Should I slow this one down a little bit?
I think you probably should.
You just downshift?
Yeah, push down.
Yeah, a little bump. Let that get through.
Throttle it up a little bit.
Get it to kick in. So it's an air throttle in this tractor. And it's nice. The reason they have an air throttle is it's simple, because they just have an air hose that goes down the engine, and when you tilt the cab up, you don't have to worry about linkage. But it's also kind of annoying too. I'm not necessarily a huge fan of an air throttle. I kind of like a cable better.
But in a situation like the compressor pump on the motor blew the top because it didn't have a pressure leak, it got stuck. And if when that did, it set the brakes. Well, you could just be seeding along or plowing along, and it would just burn those brakes up. But at least it throttled it down, so you wouldn't toast them. So
yeah,
that is that's one nice feature about having air throttle.
Yeah. Yep. Yep. That definitely happens. I used to be a farmer. Can you say hi? Can you say I lost it? Hi. I think you said hi. Thanks for being a farmer. Let's see here. Question for Leg Arms. Who came up with his nickname? A random fan did.
I have no idea.
I kind of remember the person. He said once that I was the one that did.
And that was 2016?
Yeah.
Is that when we did that in 8940?
Yeah, 1617, yeah. Something like that. Yeah. I was gonna fill up Dad, but I guess he's gonna keep going until he runs out, and we're just gonna keep seating. And then are we gonna go over there and seat his? So we'll have a little in the truck. We'll decide what we wanna do with. It's a little bit of seat. Did you give Scott a raise? No. Why would I do that? That's weird. So it's telling me now it's gonna turn in. 3, 2, 1, and turn. Tractor's turning. I'm not gonna touch anything. It's doing the headland. Now it's turning to line up with its unseated swath right here. I'm trying to hold the camera steady, sorry if it's busy. One of these days, we're going to come up with a good motion stabilization built into this type of phone.
Is my battery pack down there? Right. Oh, it's re-plugged.
Okay. Need a little juice. Better plug this in. Here, I'm going to hold it. Give this to you, Scott. You can hold it for a second.
Well, there's that. I do have that cable.
This thing, it's got a pretty fast charge rate. It doesn't take long. Go. Boom. Okay. Charging. All right. Chickpeas. Yes, we're seeding chickpeas. Really hoping that it's a good year this year. Joshua Wells, $89.50. We had an $89.40. $7. Case Crab Steer, Big Bud, or Old Steiger. Love the video. Met you at Farm Progress Show. P.S. We grow wheat in Ontario, Canada, and do you get docked or get for frugarian in Montana? I don't think, we probably do. They dock for just about everything. Our biggest dockage here is protein. That's what we get docked on. So if you don't grow very high protein, you get to take a big hit. The next up would probably be
test weight. Well,
yeah, either DHV.
Yeah,
I think it's DHV.
How
the color or falling numbers, they call it, or yeah, or test weight, and then of course if it's really dirty, you get docked there too. They dock on everything. Yeah. It's hard to bring in perfect wheat.
There's no way they'd give you perfect wheat.
Yeah.
Even if you had perfect wheat, that's downshift.
Okay. We're going through a ditch right up here. That's so I'm gonna tap this button right here. Pop into second.
Pop into first.
Pop into first. There we go. Let the cart go through nice and easy. Don't feel like breaking an axle off that thing. Now let's bump it up, throttle up. Second, let it shift. Third, there we go. This gauge right here is not accurate, in case you guys are wondering. Something's wrong with the gauge. We replaced the center unit, and the gauge still reads really high. That engine temperature is not that high with oil. That's way too high. But, yep. So, okay, where were we? Make sure I'm zoomed out all the way. There we go. Painting Big Bud purple? No, I don't think a Big Bud would look very good in purple. But it would be very unique, I guess.
Hot rod purple?
Yeah. Have you thought about getting a gimbal? I did. I actually had a gimbal once. I had a DJI Osmo
Mobile, I think is what they call it or whatever. Or something. The Osmo 2. Yeah, I did. I didn't like it. I didn't like the gimbal. It doesn't move fast enough. When you're moving around to look at stuff, it's like trying to stay where it's at. And it has a little joystick for your thumb. You can kind of maneuver around. I just didn't like it. So I prefer to hold it. It would help definitely with the bumping. But does this have a, is it an Elton transmission? No, it's a twin disc. It's a twin disc 9-speed transmission. And these were used in tugboats, mining equipment, and big mud tractors. Trying to find the right speed in this thing. There we go.
Finding that sweet spot is hard.
Ron Harmon needs to ride in that big mud. That'd be awesome. He'd probably like it.
Yeah, he left a legacy.
Yeah, Ron's been in a lot of big buds. Ron is the father, pretty much the father of big bud. He didn't necessarily invent big bud, but he took the company over when it was pretty early on, and he built it into what it is. And this is like Ron's design as this tractor. Well, kind of his engineer, but this is like, he's the one that headed this off. So, big bud tractor character belches out black smoke that spells roll coal.
Wait, what did it say?
Oh, someone was just writing up. We have those little emojis, I think, yeah. Or he's just writing up something about that's awesome. Oh. Do you have a plan for the Wagner? Yes, our plan for the Wagner is to get it running for sure. Then eventually make it look really pretty. We got to track out some tires for it, a couple odds and ends, get that old Detroit screaming Jimmy running. So it'll be fun. How fast are we going? About 5.3 miles an hour right now. Been hovering around 5. A little fast at the moment, but it'll slow down probably. So getting to the end of the field here. So it's going to, this isn't a very long field. So right here, so as soon as it gets close, that comes up telling me it's going to turn in about 4 seconds. 1. There it goes. So we are now turning. Yeah, this AccuTurn's pretty sweet. You can set it up to a teardrop, which we don't have it set up right now. A teardrop would make it so that way you wouldn't have to skip every other swath like we're doing. Teardrop turn, so basically it comes in, turns around in a big loop, comes around back in. I didn't have time to set that up, so we're just letting it do a skip every other swath. We'll play with that more as the year goes on, but yeah, definitely really exciting. Yeah. How close are you to finishing up? Probably within the next 30 minutes, 40 minutes.
Depending on what he's got.
Down there.
And then we have to go do something else with this seat.
We're really close, really close. We're going to finish today for sure. We thought the last field, but it might not be. Deke Boss Garage to work on that Detroit. That would be nice.
That guy he's a master.
Rich is awesome.
He's a master.
Yeah, Rich is a good guy.
I really enjoy what he does.
Yeah, he does some cool stuff. That guy is the kind of guy that can do anything. Put any engine in anything, and he knows those engines. He knows what he's doing.
He's not afraid to tackle a job. That's the thing. If you're willing to at least try and put the effort forth, I mean, that's all it amounts to, but chances are most people aren't even willing to try because they're afraid of failure. So
yeah, if you guys haven't checked out D-Boss Garage, check him out on YouTube. Good stuff. Instagram.
Did he hit over 400,000?
He's a little bit ahead of us in subscribers. I think he's close to 400. He had a really good run. He's got some good stuff.
I'm curious.
Yeah, they got a good editor, a really good channel. Someone said something.
399,000.
Oh, is he just under?
Okay. If you guys haven't subbed to his channel, you better break it over 399,000.
Yeah, he's at 399,000 subscribers. Just, he's under 1,000.
Go over and sub to him and break that 400.
D-Boss Garage.
That'd be sweet.
D-B-O-S Garage. Yeah.
That'd be sweet.
So, and if you guys haven't seen today's video from us, it's a good one. You should watch it. It's a good video.
And cool. Yes, if you have seen it,
watch it again.
I forget the parking brake, and the reason for is as I limped it into our bin site, it wasn't really moving that well, so when I stopped, it just stopped, and I forgot to set the parking brake, so yeah. Don't worry, it's all good. Things are safe.
I am running the Galaxy S10 phone right now, and I really like this phone, really like it a lot. It's My favorite phone so far. Very impressed with it. I normally was an LG fan because LG had the wide angle lenses, which is right here, I'll show you. So that's a regular lens. Here's the wide angle. Much nicer for doing live streams inside of small spaces like a cab. But the problem is, LG's just kind of got problems. They just aren't very reliable. And well, finally, if I can switch this over. Stop, what's going on here? Finally, they finally came out with wide angle lenses on, we'll probably be okay.
Yeah.
Wide angle lenses on Samsung Galaxies. We're going through a bump right now. That's not bad.
It's going to be a little tougher on that thing. That's not bad.
Yeah, okay. Anyways, and if you guys didn't know, we have some patrons that have their names in the tractor. I'm just going to show them. Logan Bruins and Nathan Dunlop, both farm legends. They both subscribe to Patreon, and at the tier that they're at, allows them to get their names and a pick of equipment of their choice. And they chose the Big Bud 600/50, so thanks, guys. Definitely.
So what's going to happen when somebody wants to put their name on the Minneapolis? Are you just going to, like and stick it?
We'll find a place for it. I'll have to, like, laminate it. Laminate it and then stick it somewhere.
Spray paint it on.
Tell Legarms to get a haircut.
No.
And a job.
My
job.
Really, really appreciates me with this. She never ever criticizes me for my haircut. Ever. Actually, she does.
This guy says I need to clean the shop. Well, I'm not there, so I can't do it. So I'm not going to.
He does clean the shop, but he's a busy guy. There's a lot going on.
They say your haircut looks bad. Man, they're being really judgmental on your haircut.
No, they're being honest, Nick.
Oh, I guess
there's
so.
There's a difference between judgmental and honest.
The Bomb 35 says hi.
Oh,
hi.
Hello.
Hi, The Bomb. There was a burrito that are... they don't sell it in there anymore. I've looked.
It's probably for our own good. It's like, what?
Yeah, it's
what
a lot
it,
of...
like 1,200 calories?
1,200 calories or something. They used to sell a frozen burrito at the gas station called The Bomb, and we'd eat them.
Like $3.99 or something like that. It was big.
We'd buy like two or three of them and eat them all in the same night when we were back in high school.
And we would highly hate ourselves the next morning.
Yeah.
A little
bit of bump here. Not bad. Okay. Auto turn's going on again. JC Customs, $10. Here's to a successful 2020 from Minnesota. Semi-pro grain cart driver. Nice. Semi-pro grain cart driver. That's awesome. I got my first taste of driving a grain cart last year. Definitely not a pro, but they're fun. It's wild. Driving a grain cart's wild. You gotta be on the ball. Canadian Farmer Donnie. Hey, Donnie. $5. Need to do a whole video on big equipment company and their big buds. That would be cool. That'd be cool. Maybe one of these days I get a chance to do that. I'd love to. That would be cool. Discworld 86, $10. Does the machine not do double plant on the headlands? If you're overlapping, yes, it will double plant. Yeah. It will double plant the headlands. We're just, this one's not set up to do sectional control, so it's our old drill. It's just not new enough to do that, so we just seed over it. It's just kind of we lose a little bit every year to the headlands. We do. Oh, see this? Look at this thing, if I can do it. It's asking me if I'm still in the seat. Should I say yes? Okay. So basically what that is no one had touched any of this in a certain amount of time, and just to be safe, to make sure the tractor's not randomly driving through the country because I jumped out of it, or I died in here, or whatever, it asks you that. And if I would have left that screen there, it eventually would have turned off the auto steer. The only thing about this old tractor is it's not gonna stop from driving. It's just gonna turn the auto steer off. So it'll keep going. But in a new tractor, it would actually stop the tractor from driving if you didn't press that button on auto steer, just to be safe, because that could happen. Stuff happens.
You might have downshift on this.
This is pretty bad.
Yeah.
But good question. When's the next What About Bob video? Love y'all videos. I know he wants to. All right, we got a downshift a couple times here. This one's a big one. We're gonna go real slow through it. There we go.
That one dug the tongue down a little bit.
Did it?
Yeah.
The next one's got that pull in it, so I have to be careful with the next swath back. Oh yeah, I can feel that pull. Get that turbo whistle a little bit. All right, we'll throttle her back up.
The tires, Nick.
Second. We're running in third gear.
I usually just pop it all the way up to third.
And it'll just shift up.
Just let the torque converter take it until it pops to third.
There we go. That's awesome. That thing works really nice. Really nice. Okay, where were we? Jeremy's, wow, $50. Jeremy, I'm not gonna say the last name. Simpinski, what's that? $50. Hippo character, sitting in an office chair, when they both transform into a mega chair. Hippo hero. Let me read that again. Hippo character, sitting in an office chair, when they both transform into a mecha chair. / hippo hero. That is awesome. Thank you. That's great. That's great. Thank you so much.
I think it's hilarious that you got to read those.
I know.
Thank goodness you're reading them and not me. Oh, gosh.
It's okay. I mess them up, too. Do you know why they stopped building the Big Buds? Yes, there's a lot of reasons. One of the reasons is this Big Bud right here, or at least the transmission that's in it.
Nothing wrong with the transmission.
No. Good transmission.
Great transmission.
What happened was, when Big Bud started getting into the market, there started going to be quite a demand for these large tractors across the nation. They decided to mass produce them. When I say mass produce, make like a couple hundred of them in 1 year was their goal. Like 150 or something, or 120 in 1 year.
Something like that.
So they started producing these tractors like crazy. Just bam, 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 bumping them out. Well, they went to twin disc.
Well, what it was is Ron Harmon, when they were building the 747 Big Bud, he went to a mining facility and asked, like, what's your biggest, baddest motor? And they said, that B16 Detroit. And they said, okay, what's your biggest, baddest transmission you have to, like, put behind it? And they said, that twin disc in that tractor over there with some kind of scraper. So then he went and ordered one, built the 747, had great success with it, and then they started building the Series 3. So it's 1976 is when they started building the 747. 1977 is when they finished it. And then in 1978, the later year, is when they started producing these. You might find a couple of them, but 79 is the main year that they started producing these. And you can explain about like what the transmission was.
So when they realized they wanted to make a lot of these, they went to Twin Disc and said, hey, we need like 100 and some of your transmissions by this date, you know? And Twin Disc said, oh, okay, yeah, we can do that for you. They signed an agreement. Twin Disc was going to supply them with so many transmissions, like 100 and some transmissions, or 50, I don't know, a lot of transmissions.
So then Ron Harmon went to the bank and got a loan so he could get enough money to produce, like, build these tractors, because it takes a lot of money to buy the iron and engines and all that components.
Yeah, millions of dollars back in the 70s, which is a lot of money. So they started producing these tractors, and the transmissions didn't show up. At least a few did, but not very many. And they kept making tractors, but without transmission, so they started getting parked in the lot, these useless tractors that couldn't do anything,
and there was a lot of farmers that agreed to buy a tractor, but all of a sudden, when it's getting closer to planting season, there was no tractors able to drive because there's no transmission, so they were backing out on their agreement.
I actually got pretty close to my pickup.
Oh.
Yeah. I just realized something right here. We'll pause the story, but the AccuTurn, look how close I got to my pickup. Like 3 feet away.
I knew what I was doing, right?
Yeah, like I knew what he was doing. He trusted the system. So,
these farmers were backing out of the agreements to buy these tractors, and the bank is like, hey, I want my money, and Ron Harmon's like, I need to get these tractors built and finished. So he went to Twin Disc, and then come to find out, Twin Disc, the company, was planning on building another facility to build Twin Disc transmissions. And the facility that they were at were only producing 30 of them a year.
Yeah, like 30 a year. They need like 100 of them.
They were selling those 30 ones to like mining equipment, other things that were more important than these farming tractors. So then...
More important to them.
Yeah, and this was in the 80s when interest rates were starting to go crazy and everything else was going bad. And long story short...
So they bankrupted the company.
Yeah.
They couldn't sell tractors because they didn't have transmissions to sell... So the company went under.
And the bank had some shady things that went on with the government, a few things. And
bottom line is, there were a lot of things that really hit them hard. The transmission was the biggest thing. And there was lawsuits, they sued, and litigation went on a number of years. And by the time it was all settled, it was too late, and they weren't able to recover. So then, was it the
90s or late 80s that they...
In the 80s, late 80s, they started up again.
86. Logistics.
Yeah, Meiser Tractor, a big farm in the area, went in and started helping them and made tractors again. They made the Series 4 for a couple of years, only made like 20 some of them.
Yeah.
22 of them, I think. Like they made the 740s, that's the second biggest tractor in the world.
There's two of those.
Yeah. And then they decided it wasn't going to work and they closed up doors in the early 90s, like 91 or something like that.
Yeah.
So yeah, so that's kind of in a nutshell what happened to Big Bud. And then Big Bud became Big Equipment, and Big Equipment's still around in Havre, Montana. And that's where they actually restore and rebuild some of these Big Buds. So that's a little bit of the story to Big Bud. But yeah, it's kind of a sad deal. It did make legendary tractors, though, because there's only so many of these made. It's a really big bummer. I don't know what they would have been like today. That's something I've always wondered is, if Big Bud never went out of business, if they didn't get bought by Case IH or John Deere or someone, if they didn't get picked up by any big companies.
It would be interesting to find out what they would have done.
Yeah, I don't know. It'd be really cool. So, but yeah, anyways, it's still cool. They're good tractors. They're really good tractors. Tudley, $2, would plowing the fields cover up the washes? Yes, it would. And that's one thing we didn't really have to deal with washes, because they used to summer follow, and they plow the fields all the time, and it leveled all those out. But this no-till, which is what we're doing, we do no-till on this farm.
Did you want me to farm around this, or are you going to farm around
it? I can farm around it.
Okay.
No-till, basically, we don't move a lot of dirt, so yeah, it doesn't cover that up. So we have to come back ourselves with the grader or a little plow, hook up to a small tractor or something like that, and rip it up and down and level it out, which we will do. Just didn't get this one done. This guy says, Scott's coffee, Nick. I wouldn't get close.
We have to work together, good. So if one of us is sick,
yeah,
it's gonna get sick.
There's a hawk flying around. He's been like trying to land on the tractor. All right.
Do you want me to hold on to that?
I'm sure. If you want to take it, you can switch between screens if you want.
Okay.
There you go.
Yeah. So right here, there's a post. Right there. He's gonna farm around that, and that's actually a big line that's exposed for gas line, because it got washed out, and sweet. Oh, yes it is. The camera doesn't give it justice. It's probably, I don't know, maybe 2 feet deep.
I do love this power shift transmission for this.
And don't. There we go. Nice. Can you see?
Yep. And we gotta go back to that ditch again.
Try
not to plug those things. I did plug them. A bunch of them are plugged. The fan's probably dropping in speed too. That's probably why we're plugging them.
No, you're turning so sharp it mushed it in. I'll have to go underneath there with a pick and dig out the dirt. When you get on the other side, I might as well just get out.
Okay.
And clean it out.
Clean them out. Head back to the ditch again.
And here we go. It would have been nice to be able to get the grader up here and fix this, but we got a lot of things on our plate, and we just have to sacrifice this year on fixing this, so.
And right. There we go. Pull it up.
Okay, you want to lift it out of the ground, and I'll go fix that?
So we got a few blocks. Oh, that's going to be stopped, yeah. So it's pretty much all on that side.
There you go.
All right. All right, we got to unblock a couple things. I'm going to take my battery pack with me. So what happened, I'll show you guys out here. If the wind is bad, I apologize. Hopefully that windsock helps a little bit that I got on here. All right. So turning sharp, the hoe drill kind of has to skid because that side spot, or it's that pivoting basically in the center there. And it, as it's skidding, what happens is it shoves mud up into the boot, and this is pretty wet
soil right now, so it's clumpy, and it plugged all these. So he's got a little tool he's using to dig in there. I guess I got a Leatherman in my pocket. I could use that. Where's that thing at? Help him out. I actually have a magnet on this thing. Let's stick. Flip this around. I'm onto something here. There we go. Nice. Okay. Those chickpeas don't flow very well. Alright, that one plugged too. That's good.
I think it was just those three. That one's good.
Yeah.
The rest of those are okay.
Okay. Air coming out of the bottom of that one?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. Alright.
There we go. Oh, it's nice here. I'll show you the ditch that we were talking about. This is what we've been driving over. Just to give you guys an idea of how big this thing is. So right here. Let me flip the camera around so you can see a little better. Oops. Come on, camera. Cell phone service might not be that good here, so I apologize. I'm standing in it. It's about a foot and a half, 2 feet deep, about 3 feet wide, and the gas line goes right here. But let me get out of there because I bet the service is probably dropping off. Is there one still? Up. Did you fix it yet?
I guess so.
What about now? Why do you keep kicking it?
By the way, if I reverse this camera,
there's nothing happening over here.
Say the barn door is open, the moose are getting out, and yeah, a lot of liquid.
I don't know what you're talking about. Makes no sense at all. Oh, there's the guy. All right, let's get back in the tractor. Bent down. All right.
What's bent down?
Okay. Put this back like that. I got to look at something down here. Hang on. Let's go down here and take a look. Sorry, guys. Small delay. What's that?
What's wrong?
Isn't this bent down a little bit? This piece right here? Has it?
Yeah.
It's always had a little bit of a... Huh.
No.
Seems like it's more to me. What's that?
It's fractured here.
Oh, wow. Oh, that side too. That's not good.
Well,
way better
to
finish planing.
It's going to just drop down and dry.
We just saw something, but it will rip all these out that happened?
No, because it's got a little pin out, but it's just going to drop that down.
I'll show you guys. You should probably grab your camera and show that. I just noticed I walked over here. It's kind of slumping on this bar right here. It's fractured right here and right over there. It's breaking off. And I don't know how much longer that's going to last. Thank goodness we're about done with planting. That's got to be reinforced. This wasn't designed for a heavy air cart. It was designed to pull a plow. Oh, boy. I wonder how long that's going to last. That would be bad. Well, we need to get the weight out of this, so we got to keep seeding. We have a little bit left. We'll just take it real easy. Huh. You know what? It's because he's been driving this thing. That's what's going on. He broke it. That guy. But he can fix it. We'll reinforce that and make that way stronger. Yeah, it needs reinforced. That's amazing. Leg arm stepped on it. There is a lot of tongue weight on here, and that was not in the plans when they built these tractors. This they had heavier duty hitches. This bud does not have it. And I can see right now we got to do something about that. That needs fixed. Oh, I drove it last. That's right. That's right, I did. Oh, I can't blame leg arms. Okay. Well, let's get back in the tractor. I was looking at that and I was like, why does it have a smile to it? Like, that shouldn't have a smile like that.
You know, come to think about it, I thought I heard a pop when I was going up that hill over there.
Really?
I literally thought I heard something.
Hopefully I didn't block anything. No, good. Okay. Got that one run on forest blocks, but...
Yeah, that's not good.
I don't want that to break off. We'll have to be careful.
Oh, I'll watch it.
Yeah, I'll just have to take it real easy. Fortunately, it's not. It's just the weight. It's not being pulled on because the tongue is attached to the center of the hinge of the tractor. But still.
Well, you better see that weight out, Nick.
Yeah, I know.
You got two block runs still.
I know. We could just...
And you're probably going to just catch it all up. I bet you anything you're blocked at all.
It probably did. Turn this up a little bit.
Maybe you got lucky.
Okay. So, anyways, that's not good.
Yeah, I don't know what you do about that. I might have to run a new live stream because you have to, like, keep the air flowing.
Those were there
when we started. Those three were there right when we turned around. Okay. They probably plugged when we went through that last dip and we slowed down.
There's blockages if you guys are wondering right there. Anyways, okay.
Yeah, if you want to take over, I can let you run it.
Well,
when we get to the end, I'll go out and clean those up.
Got a couple blockages on the runs. The fan pressure drops when you lower the tool down to the ground. Yeah, I'm thinking we're going to have to do something big on that because, that's not going to work. That's got to get reinforced big time. So we'll make that, really heavy. Really heavy.
I just can't believe that.
That piece was pretty built to have it break out like that. Anyways, just think of the views if it breaks off. Yeah, I know. I know. I'm not... That's why I told Scott to grab his camera because that could be in a future video. So he's gonna stop and there's three blockages again. We'll get those fixed. We gotta see the end passes. What do we got? An hour and 52 minutes? Oh boy. It's been a long stream.
That just makes me nervous.
I really don't want that to break off.
That does. Well, I'm gonna go up here, turn around in that grass, then I'll unplug them and seed back this end pass and walk up there and see that one.
Okay.
Because we're done on this.
I wonder how long it's been like that. I guess, I mean, the weight in the cart is definitely less. We've got... But yeah. If that does break, it's going to shove that drawbar down. And then you're going to have a hard...
tractor. Yeah, it's going
to be... Get the seat out of the ground, so... Or out of this drill. And get this thing back.
Now that... When I was going up this hill, I did hear a pop of some sort. And I thought... Oh, okay. Just figured it was just horsepower. Telling it's horsepower.
Huh.
Okay.
Yeah, that's really weird.
This is...
Okay.
Which runs were they?
Yeah. One, three, and...
Okay, one, three, four.
Four just disappeared. Nope, it's back.
Okay, one, three, and four.
Okay. Anyways.
These are fun. They know.
He's going to go dig those out again. I'll hang out with you guys and read some comments for a minute.
All right.
Or I could have him stay here and read comments and I could go dig them out.
Oh, no, I don't mind doing this.
Did your family buy the Big Buds new? We bought one of them new. And that was the very first one, Series 1, my grandpa bought new. Other than that, the other two we bought used. The Series 2 bought about a year old, 2 years old. It was pretty new. And then this one was in 2008 is when we bought it, so it had a lot of time on it.
It's a well-used tractor. It's a very well-used tractor. This tractor probably has 10 to 15,000 hours on it, and that down there is part of that. So yeah, it's a sad day when Big Bud closes his doors. Yeah, it was. I was a little pipsqueak when that happened, so I didn't know. But it's sad to me now. And a lot of people lost their jobs. Too bad. Thank you for the donation, too, by the way. Multi-Hunter, $5. Is it true that there is still one of Big Equipment that has not been finished? Yes, it is true. There's actually a couple frames that they have. One big one, too. It's pretty big. It could be a monster. It's got a V12 Cummins in it right now, an old V12, I think twin-turbo Cummins in it. But it's just wait for the right person to come by and dump a bunch of money into it. And if they do, they'll have a monster tractor. How is Big Equipment doing after the last fire? I honestly don't know. I haven't talked to them. I haven't talked to them since then. So hopefully they're doing well. It's really sad they had another fire. But yeah, it's really unfortunate. Hopefully they get a good number of years here of really good, no bad things. Time to get a quad track. Well, I'll tell you what, a quad track would not be breaking like that. That's we're gonna make that big. We'll fix this. That's gonna take some serious iron. We're gonna have to look up, find some good iron. But just looking at that piece, that's got to be rebuilt. And we'll make a way better hitch on this thing. It's just really nice though that this is the last day of planting and we're this close to being done. Because that would have been really a bummer if that would have come off. So, yeah. Wrap a chain around it. I should. If there was a good place up here to hook a chain to, you could drop it down. Just need it so it doesn't drop down. The drawbar is underneath there, and it can't, if it breaks off, it can't like disconnect. I mean, it's still going to stay attached to the tractor, and the tractor's going to keep dragging that thing. It's just, it'll drop down, and it'll start riding on the ground, and that's what I don't want. A tow behind cart, you wouldn't have this. That's why they make those really big carts tow behind, because the weight then is not on the tractor. It's kind of nice having the weight on the tractor because it puts a little bit of weight on the rear axle here, so you get a little more traction. But yeah. What's my favorite Big Bud? Well, I like this tractor a lot. I like the Series 2 a lot too. The Series 2 is very simple. That's what's really nice. Jaden Wilcutt, should I be a farmer? I would definitely say find a place where you can work for a little bit on a farm and see what you think. It's not everybody's cut out to be a farmer. It's tough to become a farmer, but farming is a very rewarding life. A lot of really good things come of it. And, you know, it's a good place to raise a family, too. So, what happened? Well, there's a couple plug runs on the air drill, which is right here, over here. Leg Arms is out there digging those out at the moment. The second thing that happened is the drawbar, which is right down here, the support that holds up the drawbar is literally cracking and breaking off right now. I noticed it as we were walking over, and it looked like it was kind of like a smiley face. And I'm like, that wasn't like that when we were working on it in the shop. And I asked Leg Arms that, and I'm like, he goes, no, it's always been like that. I'm like, I don't think so. And then you look closer, and there's big cracks all around the sides where it's breaking that whole piece off. So, yeah. Brian Anderson, is this the Brian Anderson that I know from Shelby? It probably did get it stuck. Actually, you guys, I'll tell you where you get this thing stuck. It's right here. That's not in our field, that's our land. But see that? That's an alkaline bottom there. It would bury this tractor if I drove in that. Absolutely bury it. So I'm not going in there. Absolutely not. But, I mean, we could. Leg Arms isn't here to stop me. No, we won't do that. Let's see here. How much does a tractor weigh as is? It's about 52 to 55,000 pounds without any water in the wheels. You can put, I call it water. It's not just water. It's just like a salt mixture so it doesn't freeze. But you can put liquid in the wheels and then weigh it down to about 75,000 pounds. But we don't really need that. We're not pulling anything heavy enough to need that. Except for that breaking off the end. So, but yeah, the tractor weighs about 55,000 pounds. Full of fuel. Has to be completely full of fuel to get that. Let's see. How far are you from finishing? Literally like under 100 acres. We probably got about 50 acres left and we're done. Like 50. No joke. We're close. We're really close. And I'm a little nervous about this tractor making it now because of that thing down there. Is the lake house finished? Not yet. It's close. as soon as we're done farming, I'm up there and I gotta work on it hard. There's a lot of things to get done. I should be wiping these windows down. Do we have anything here? Let's go wipe some windows. They're really dirty. Switch, as you can see there. Say two were plugged? Yeah, that's good enough. I don't care about going to the other window. Yeah, I hope it makes it.
No,
that's
like,
got me nervous.
Like that much on this side.
Here, you can drive.
Are you sitting there?
Yeah, you can drive. That's fine. Oh, what am I sitting on?
Paper towel roll.
Might have to take it slower then.
Yeah, that's not good. We don't want to balance it, that's for sure. I don't know. It's like, in this situation, what do? Do you stop, you unhook the tractor, and leave this air drill here and hook the other tractor up to it and finish seam with it to avoid breaking that off? But the thing is, it's so damaged that it needs to come off anyways.
And it can't hurt the cart.
It's not going to hurt the cart. If it falls down, it's just going to give us a hassle trying to get it unhooked then. Well, I guess you might be able to get the pin out and still drive forward.
You should be able to.
And the jack might lift it up if it doesn't squish down to the ground. Otherwise, we'll have to get the front end loader and lift the front of that up. Or, best case scenario is it doesn't break, we finish planting, and we get it back to the farmyard, and we deal with it there. What do you guys think? Keep going? Thumbs up? Don't go? Thumbs down?
That's crazy it busted like that.
I know. I looked at it, and I was like, that looks like it's like bent down. But it literally bent that piece, and it breaking the welds off.
We might as well... I wonder if that the bud that we took the hood off of for the big root, I wonder if that one's got a decent one.
Well, remember those drawbar hookups like for the industrial? See, they made an industrial version of this tractor, and it has a massive hitch that's bolted to like the inch thick frame.
We could see if, yeah, they might have something.
And it's solid. And this thing is, this hitch is so low on this tractor too, it'd be really nice if it were up a little higher, the drawbar. But still, they made one.
You could take that drawbar, take it off, and not even use it, because it doesn't really...
Yeah, we don't need it. Well, yeah, we don't really need it, if it's solid there.
We're not ripping, like, ridiculous things for this tractor.
No. Everyone says keep it going. No pain, no gain.
No,
thumbs
sure
up, thumbs
that.
Up, thumbs up, thumbs up. Everyone wants us to keep going.
Well, we're getting so weary and tired, we want to just go home and sleep.
In case we get an awesome moment here, let me pull this camera out and turn this thing on. Hang on, guys, I gotta talk for a second here. So I've been riding along with leg arms doing a live stream, and well, we were out cleaning some boots and noticed a bent piece on the drawbar that supports the drawbar, and as we look closer, it's breaking off, literally breaking off. And we only have literally like 30 acres left to plant, maybe 40 at most. To be done, and we get this back to the yard. We decide to push through, so we're just gonna push through, see if we get this tractor back. If it breaks, I guess it'll make a great thumbnail, and yeah. And I'm not driving it, so I can't get in trouble. He's been really hard on this tractor.
I have.
Oh well, that's okay. We'll reinforce it, we'll make it bigger, badder than ever. It'll be awesome. But yeah, right now it's kind of disappointing that it's literally doing that. So, all right, we'll find out what happens. Hang on.
mean, you can't have a perfect end of the season year, so.
No. It's got to be one big oopsie.
Oh.
Wow. Yeah. That's okay, guys. Even big butts get hurt sometimes. But nothing we can't fix. How much fuel do you guys burn through a planting?
I would be curious to know. I bet you.
That's a very good question.
Probably burn about 3/4 gallon an acre. And that's just over 7,500 acres to plant. 3/4 gallon. So you're looking at about 5,000 gallons of diesel fuel. And then you got to factor in the sprayer, the land roller, all the trucks
that drive.
We could burn through 10,000 gallons of diesel, probably. I bet you 10,000 before the season's done. 10,000 gallons.
You're talking about like harvest too, or just?
No, just planting. Just planting.
I mean, it's possible. Well, we got more acres this year that we're putting in, so yeah, it's very possible to win.
Yeah.
About that.
These tractors are surprisingly fairly fuel efficient for what they are. They're not as bad as you'd think. They're definitely not like as high tech as today's tractors, new tractors, but they're really simple. So you want leg arms to drive so he breaks it, not you. Absolutely.
That's exactly what I want to
do. I'm not touching that steering wheel. I saw what's back there.
You break it, you fix it, so
I'm just here tagging along.
That seems most logical.
You know, I was actually the one that spotted it, and I haven't even driven this tractor.
That's true, you did spot it. I'm actually the one that broke it because I've been driving it the most.
But I was actually the one peeing on the tire back there.
Well, what do you think broke it, Nick?
It's not going to corrode it that fast.
Yeah, but it adds more drag on the tire, Nick. Got a little extra weight.
A little mud sticking to the side. Sorry.
Guess who has to change that tire, Nick?
Probably not me.
True.
No. I might have to. Here's our neighbor's field right over here, by the way.
So what do we want to do then? Do we want to try to auger what we have left in the other truck and then Dad finishes?
Can Dad drive home?
I don't know.
We should probably call him and find out where he's at. Make sure he's...
If he's still here...
I don't think I want to use this tractor anymore. If we can see this out, we need to take this tractor back home.
Well, we can drop the manifold and auger it into the truck.
Yeah,
and then
we should do that. Yeah, he's going to call Dad.
It probably won't last to do those other acres.
We'll leave you guys on. I know 3,000 people are watching. That's a lot.
Wow.
This is a long stream too, 2 hours long. I didn't know when to start it. I was like, well, I could do it right at the end of the live stream, or right at the end of when we finish planting, or I could do a little before. So I just started it. Just don't load it again. I'm not going to. Definitely not going to. We're thinking actually of finishing this field and then going back up to the truck. And then we'll drop the manifold, use the auger, and unload what's left in that grain cart to get all the weight out of it into the truck, which is up here. Then run the tractor home, get it parked in the yard, shut it down, and then finish planting with the other tractor. And that's why we have two rigs on the farm, in case this happens. So, it was the high pressure that broke it. Loving the live stream. Thanks. Thank you guys for being a part of this. You guys are making it fun. And I'm trying to hold this camera steady for you guys. Hi from Saskatchewan. We're almost done seeding up here too. Awesome. We'll race ya. We're on track to run to finish tonight. So I hope you guys are close. A lot of guys around us are right around the time they're almost finishing. Some are real close, some are not. So you're done at the end pass down there?
Yeah, and then I'm going to have to go up to this corner and start seeing
you
that.
You go a little faster.
Yeah.
It's not going to be any bumpier.
So he's not picking up his phone, either he's out unclogging stuff, or...
He could be, yeah.
Or he's,
So we finished all those...
Yeah.
You just have the one headland at this end?
Yeah, we just got to do the end pass, and then we're done.
We're close. We're really close, guys. Y'all want to see what we're looking at right now? Here's the dilemma of doing a live stream, the last little bit of planting, is I should be making video content for the YouTube channel and a regular video that I'm live streaming. So I'm going to do both. So you guys are going to have to put up with me occasionally stopping and filming myself. That'll be in a real video, just so you know, which I'm going to do right now. turn this thing on. Okay.
Doesn't it feel awkward that you're, like, talking in front of people, Nick? Like,
I'm not talking to anybody.
Yeah, doesn't it feel awkward, though?
No one watches my stuff.
Oh, okay, well, then it should not feel awkward at all.
No.
Okay, as long as it's not awkward.
I just do this because it's fun.
There's a nice goat right there.
Oh, yeah, there's a nice antelope right there. Okay, I'll put the camera down. I'll put the camera down real quick. I'll show you guys this buck right here. He's
probably about...
He's not a trophy, but... Yeah. He's watching us. We're watching you, buddy. You keep growing.
Okay, on the count of three, jump out and run after him.
Should I run after him? On three? Oh, there he goes. He'll be a nice buck someday. Yeah, we were here earlier, buddy. You saw us. Those things are the weirdest animals. If you guys don't know much about antelope, they're the fastest animal in North America.
Are they really?
Yep. Fastest animal in North America. They are so fast, they have eyeballs like binoculars. Let's see, there we go. They can see things literally miles away. It's unreal. They're really a really remarkable animal.
And they taste pretty good.
I would know. Yes, I would. They're actually a pretty sweet animal. And we have a lot of them right now. antelopes are not cantaloupes. Are you sure? They call them speed goats, actually.
It hasn't broke off yet.
Oh, you know what it did?
Huh.
When you went through that deep ditch, the tractor went like this, and it put pressure on the tongue and the tractor because it was binding, and it forced it down. That's why it's got a bow and it's cracked down.
So that just happened?
It must have.
Do you see what's going on here? Legarms is trying to blame me now.
No.
That I broke it.
I'm going to be, like, awake at night thinking about this, why it broke.
Yeah, but it would have to bend the drawbar to do that.
Well, when I went through that dip, it went like this, and I was looking at it, and it's very possible, because the way it's got, it's bowed inward, and it's trying to crack it down. It's not like, I don't know.
Well, maybe. I don't know. I mean, maybe. It might have happened.
I bet you anything, because it's from 1979, I bet you it's just had a lot of years on it.
Well, we've planted with this before. We've had it hooked up to the air cart.
Yeah, but like...
Something definitely happened. And it might have been right there.
It was a pretty, like, deep ditch right there when you're going through and I was watching, but I wouldn't have thought... I don't know. I think it's just stress from all the years.
That might have been it. I mean, honestly, it might have been me. I might have broke it.
No. I broke it because I've been one driving it the whole time. Yeah, you just witnessed it.
You did break it.
That's exactly how it went. We're good at breaking things.
We're debating. See here.
Okay.
Can I turn this thing on again?
I don't know.
There we go. It's recording? Yes, it is. So Legarms and I are debating who broke the tractor. Now he has a theory that I drove it through a deep ditch and it basically sandwiched or pinched the drawbar as I went through and crushed it down. I think he's just trying to blame me.
I think he's catching on.
I don't know. But so far, it's staying together. We're really kind of nervous that we're all of a sudden going to hear a big clunk and look back and it's going to be dragging in the ground. But it hasn't happened yet. We've got just a little bit left on this field. Literally like one end pass and we'll be done. So hopefully it survives. What a way to end the season is breaking your beloved tractor. I'm not pointing fingers. I can't. I'm holding two cameras. See, I told you. I can't point fingers. My hands are full.
Do you want three?
I could try to hold a third camera here. That's why we got magnets on them. I can't do this. There's another one.
Okay. You got to do this, Nick.
Yeah, we're in the circle of cameras.
All right. I better put this out.
You should probably drive the tractor.
Yeah,
Otherwise, you're going to break something else. You did already see that back there.
I thought I was going to get stuck back there, so I tried to seat it out this way.
Well, maybe we should reenact that moment. We'll go back to that ditch. We'll drive through it again and see what it looks like when it pinches it really hard.
That is a fantastic idea.
Only you'll drive it, though. I'll get outside and I'll watch. Can't be that bad, right? Put the camera on your head. Head cam. Okay, I'll hold it here. There's the head cam. dragging something.
Oh, it's a box. Never mind.
That yeah, I
really sticky.
A little slipper here?
No, it was sticky.
Oh.
Like, I didn't have it throttled up enough and it downshifted.
A little bit of mud. Oh, man. I'm glad we're almost done. That would have been a real bummer if this would have happened at the beginning of the season. Who is older? I am by a little bit. Not much. 1 year. 1 year older. Alan E., $2. Saturday Night Welker Entertainment. Yes. It's like Saturday Night Live. Literally.
Yeah, literally. But not as funny.
Saturday Night Live. Yeah, just not as funny. We're not nearly as funny as those guys.
No.
Not nearly as good of actors either. Like that Zach Johnson. Phenomenal actor. It's an Oscar in the making.
So I kind of wonder if he went back, because I didn't see him drive back. He hasn't answered his phone yet.
I never saw him drive back either. I don't know where he's at. Did Scott take the draw off during the restore? He did. He did, and it was better then. It wasn't broke like that. The draw bar was in good condition. It's the bracket that holds the draw bar.
Hey, where
is
you at?
What's bent. So we have one pass up and down
this
field.
Okay, so what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to drop all the seed out of this drill and put it in the truck.
He's talking to Dad.
Because the draw bar, the bracket that holds it to the back frame is actually breaking off.
Very surprising. This is not our machinery here.
What we're going to have to do is
that's our truck.
It out with that drill.
This is not ours. Oh, wait, that's ours right there, the Fummins. Fummins is parked in the mix.
So we're going to finish out this end pass, and then we'll drop it out, or drop the manifold, then drop the rest of it in the truck. Okay. All right, sounds good, Dad. Okay. He's literally finishing up the end pass over there.
Oh, is he done with it? So he had enough to finish?
Yeah, he barely.
Barely had enough to finish? Good. Okay, so we are in the last field. Technically, we have a little bit more to seed, though. Probably better not go too fast, yeah. I mean, I guess if it breaks off and it just drags, but then you'll mess that jack up.
You're going to mess up the tongue of it.
We don't want to mess that up.
Worst case scenario, you have to drop it and then
get the other tractor
here.
Go bring the 435 butt up here, hook on and pull it back.
You could, yeah. That might be the safest route.
Well, I mean, just take if we chance. Get it empty, even the 4520 deer pull it back.
Yeah, I've pulled, yeah.
I mean, you could even, if you long it up, that
or,
is.
Or I just get down there and strong arm it together until get home.
You could bench press that straight again.
I could probably do that, but I don't want to show. Oh, I haven't been in the gym for like 2 months since
COVID. Yeah, you could
so
do that, actually.
No, I couldn't do that. No
way. Maybe the Minneapolis Marine could pull it back.
That would be sweet.
That would make a great thumbnail. That poor drawbar and that thing would break right off.
I know for a fact it could definitely pull it downhill.
Yeah, it could pull it downhill. It could pull it downhill. It's still on back there. I don't know, guys.
I'm astonished that even... I'm glad you saw that.
We've gone through so many ditches like that before, though.
But it's weird because it's like bowing down further than it was before. And then the way it's cracking is it's trying to pull it down. It's cracking from the inside, not the outside.
I don't know. That's really weird. Really weird.
I mean, what do we estimate on this tractor? Like... probably 15,000 hours on this tractor.
I bet 15,000 hours on it.
Because when we got this tractor, that hour meter said just a little over 2,000 hours, and I think that's when they did the engine rebuild. And this tractor's had 3 transmissions rebuilt in it, and I would say probably 15,000 hours is what this tractor's got on.
Yeah, something like that.
And it shows.
Yeah, but that was not like that when we started the season, so something definitely happened, and it might have been me.
Well, you can see... No, it was me.
No, it was me.
No, I insist.
No, I did it.
I literally insist.
No, I'm pretty sure I was the one that did it.
No, Nick, you can't take credit for everything.
I broke the big bud.
But guess what? I'm the guy that created Welker Farms YouTube. Yeah, you take the credit for everything, Nick.
If anybody's going to break something around here...
It's going to be me.
All right, I guess you can take the blame for this one. But
I feel like this is like one of those Bugs Bunny moments where like somehow...
No, you're good. I wanted to be blamed, but you can.
You should actually probably take it. I'm feeling bad, actually.
I mean, I'll help you fix it. I don't know how we're gonna bend that piece straight. That thing is thick. We're gonna have to get a new one.
Yeah, I think so too.
We're gonna have to just redesign the way that whole thing's built back there. Where are you gonna get iron that thick?
We might have to have
special order it or have somewhere
some place to cut it out.
Yeah, that's like a 2.5 inch thick chunk of iron.
We just say, hey buddy, Ron Harmon, buddy old pal, what do you got there?
The thing is you have to cut, you can take that piece off, that's right.
That's what I'm saying, like
that
off
is,
that
you could unbolt that.
The 430 might not.
Oh yeah, that's right. There could be one over there. We might be able to track down one of those. It's actually a piece that can unbolt and come off. I forgot about that. It's not permanently welded on the tractor. So we can take that piece off. We could probably bend it straight, actually. We just gotta take it to a place that has a heavy enough press. I don't think our press could even touch that. So we would need something that's like 100 ton press, probably.
Well, if I go to the gym more often, maybe.
There's Dad, right there. You guys see Dad? That's Bob. Bob and the Big Bud. And there's Kobe, right? Oh, I'm focusing on the window. Stop focusing on the window. Come on, camera. Focus on Dad.
You would think that dog would be deaf with that engine just
I know.
Like that.
It's amazing.
Where's my camera at?
Yep. Turn this thing on.
Okay, I predict 10 feet to the very end of this field.
10 feet, it's gonna fail?
It's gonna break. I predict it.
Break at 10 feet.
And if it breaks 10 feet to the end of the field, then everybody owes me a dollar.
If it breaks at 10 feet for the field.
Yeah, everybody owes me a dollar.
Everyone's watching, that's $3,100.
Yeah, and guess what? I'm gonna go buy a new hitch with that.
That'd probably buy you maybe the labor of doing a hitch.
Well, at least it helps.
So, Dad's back there with the tractor. He just finished his field. That means we're on the last field. Technically, though, we do have some seed left over, so we might have to find one more spot on the farm to finish planting all this. The issue is still there. The drawbar is hanging on. It's a bracket that holds the drawbar up. It can be unbolted, so we will be able to take it off after season, look at it, figure out a way to either reinforce it, rebuild it, replace it.
I don't know.
Somehow. But, yeah.
You're not going to flex seal it?
We could flex seal it.
We should probably try that. I mean,
we could try flex seal.
Trevor does it.
Trevor Bales would totally do that.
Yeah, he always does it.
Yeah. I don't trust anything that guy
somehow,
says.
Trevor's always got a sandwich in his mouth. Or like
an ice cream bar.
Yeah, always ice cream, right?
Such a fatty. Oh, Dad's seat in the past behind you.
What?
He's back there seating.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
Sure?
Yeah, he's seating on the left over here.
Oh.
Unless he's just dragging it. I don't know.
Okay, well.
Okay, I'm gonna turn this camera off. Put that camera down there. All right, so guys, I'm sorry. There's a lot going on. I have not been paying attention to you. It's like a few of you there. Toby is the best farm dog ever. $2. Yes, he is. He's a pretty cool dog.
Neglected? Do you guys feel neglected?
I
think you should.
I feel neglected.
I haven't been paying attention.
My phone is not charging.
Why is it not charging?
Fix this. Got to press the little button on here. And boom, now it's charging. Okay. Flex seal tape. Yes. I'm sure. If you put.
They make a tape?
They do.
Really?
I bet if you wrap that with 2,000 rolls of Flex Seal tape, it would hold together.
It's something like Red Green Show would do with duct tape.
Jason Wolf, $1. Thank you, Jason. Farmall Skittle, $2. Flex Seal the hitch. What could we use? Flex Seal's pretty good. I don't know how that couldn't hold. It's actually a really pretty sight back there with all the tractors coming. I better turn around and show you guys. I know. What a time to have that fail like that.
And the worst part is I'm not the one running out faster. He was.
Yeah.
If his did it, it would have been okay. Because, like, well, it is what it is, but.
There we go. Wire with electrical tape. Definitely. We could wire with electrical tape. Is Dad finishing? Oh, he's just pulling it up. Okay.
Then I'm going to finish this pass here and then...
One last pass. I don't know if I should celebrate and say that's the end of farming, planting 2020.
You should, because then something bad's going to happen and people are going to love the realistic
Well, we still have a little bit of seed, and
it's got to go somewhere.
So there is...
Well, that little tiny bit over there, that I don't know if that's enough for that, though.
I could have a heavy dose.
We got to evaluate what's in the truck. That's the only way to do it, really, know.
You can put a lot on it. There's probably 20 acres, maybe, of that 40.
Okay.
Or so that's left.
If we were really far away, I think what we'd do is we'd bring the welder over here and the grinder, and
Or we would weld
those cracks up real well for the time being to get us back. But
or you'd end up dropping the cart, take this back, weld it up at the shop, and then come back.
Well, we should definitely empty this cart, get it all out.
I don't want to see any more with it.
No, this is a ticking time bomb. This thing's, it's not going to stay like that forever. That's going to fall off.
Is there any, like, we basically got Steiger parts on this tractor. Can we just go to, like, a used Steiger factory and, like, take these off it?
We can steal some off the Wagner.
Yeah!
The Verstile.
Oh, yeah, we do have the Verstile. I bet you anything that one on that 430 would work great.
It probably has that piece.
I bet you it does.
That is really weird. That's a first. Never seen that happen.
And
the mystery is done. Are we done?
3, 2, 1,
yay! Is that it?
Pull it out of the ground.
Okay, technically we're like sort of done, but we're not. We finished the field. Dad finished his field. The tractor is still going. But we have a little bit of seed left in the truck and some seed left in this cart here that we got to get out. And we got to get out of this one, definitely, because that drawbar is not hanging on much longer. Two, we got to find a piece to seed the rest of those peas out on, or beans, those chickpeas. Chickpeas, garbanzo beans, whatever you want to call it, they got to go somewhere because they're inoculated, which means they have a shelf life of just a couple days of inoculant. So we'll put them all in his drill, since that other tractor is good to go, and go find a field and go finish this. Sound good? What do you think?
I just felt fat.
I could eat a lot of pizza after today. I say we have a Pizza Hut run. This is all done. And then I'm going to go sit in the sprayer for 2 days straight. Because I have a lot of spraying ahead of me.
I'm winging it.
Okay, wing it up. Wing it. Let's get this set up. Okay, camera's off. I do like the auto on, auto off feature on these things. And it's got a front screen on it, and I don't even use it half the time.
You're not even letting them see that, Nick.
What, wing it up? Oh, yeah. I'm sorry.
Jeez, they almost missed the show.
I'm sorry. I would shut this off, because normally I'd be like, I gotta go, because there's stuff going on, but you guys are all here and I can't turn it off now. So if you don't mind, occasionally I might just like plop the camera down. You'll see us in the background doing stuff. You just won't get talked to, so you guys don't talk to each other.
Explain them why we're gonna, or how we're gonna drop the manifold.
Okay, so what's happening is we finished this field. There's still seed left in this tank. We gotta get it out of there, because we're not gonna be able to seed it out, because we're done seeding with this tractor, because it's like breaking. So we need to get that seed from there into that truck right there, to then take that truck and put it into that seeder right there. Does that make sense? So we gotta drop the manifolds. It's on the bottom of the air cart. And there we go. Oh, all right, so keep winging this up. Let me flip your camera around here. Okay, let's take a look at the drawbar real quick, see what the damage is. All right, let's look at this drawbar.
So if my theory, no, it didn't hit. I was wondering if it, like, it was such a deep draw that it pinched it.
Yeah.
But it doesn't look like it hit there.
The cracks are right here. See that crack?
So it's almost completely broke off right here on both sides. There's just a little bit.
And it's got a big smile to it.
So, I can't see anymore. I'm getting all the awesome.
Nice excuse.
Yeah, Scott broke it.
It's like a chain from right there on a boomer. I didn't do it. He did it. There's no way I did it. I've been cleaning the shop the whole time. I haven't even been farming.
Yeah, but if you, yeah, you could. You can see if you hook it right around the chain, right around that over there, you can move it.
Keep it from hanging down. I think it'll make it home. We just got to get the weight out of it. So, he's going to drop the manifold. Hey, Scott, did you, oh yeah, you did. Okay. So it's in that one right there. We gotta take the seat out of that. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. Okay. So Dad's bringing the truck around. We'll drop the rest of the seat out of that thing. Do you have the lever pulled? Yeah, you do. I got my Leatherman in my pocket if you want it. Let's take a look at this again. I don't know if you can see the smile to it. So what we're afraid of is this breaking off right here and this falling down. I'm going to redo this again because I'm talking to this other camera. So what we're afraid of is that breaking off right there and falling down. It's really slow, these things. What, the tank? Yeah, there's quite a bit in there. Here, it's gonna take a while.
So if I open this up, it won't go faster?
Doesn't go any faster, we tried. It's the same speed. It just takes a while. Why can't you just leave it running? Just let it go. What he's doing right now is he's getting ready for roading. It's just a safety piece, so that way when he's driving down the county road, it doesn't settle down and plow the county road up. That's happened. It actually happened this year. So those safety locks are for the cylinders, just stop it so it can't collapse down. A lot of slop in that, isn't there?
Well, it's not tight enough.
It's loose right there. Yeah, it's a good thing we're about done. We can go over here while that thing's going. It's going to take a while to empty that hopper out. So I'm going to walk over here. That's old trusty right there. That tractor, since we rebuilt it, it's been solid. And I don't know if this piece is just stronger here or what, but I've never had that cracking issue with that. That's never shown any signs of fatigue like that. So that's really... really weird what happened. I don't know. I'm kind of, I don't know the word flabbergasted, but I'm a little perplexed as to what in the world caused that drawbar support like that to fail. It's got me confused. And that's how she folds together. It's an old design, but a lot of equipment manufacturers still use the same kind of design like this is. It's a not that I'm saying it's the best, it's definitely archaic compared to what's out there today. But it gets the job done, and it's pretty cheap for us right now. But we do need to eventually make an upgrade and go to some better drills. They're showing their age. I don't know where Kobe's at. He was here somewhere. He's probably chasing rabbits around. Where's that dog at? At least the wind isn't blowing as hard as it was. It was pretty windy earlier today. It's gonna be a nice sunset too. This'll be great. See the paint flaking off there. Look at that. Well, Legarth was wondering if I went through a ditch and this fell down and that fell down, if it caused this to kind of buckle right here. Hard to say. Really is hard to say. But you can unbolt this piece, you can see. You can take this whole unit off, and we'll do that, and then we'll figure out how to go about bracing this. Either we'll save this piece, because we can reinforce this real easy. We can easily put some heavy iron here and triangle this up, cut into that, weld it back up, triangle it. This used to pivot back and forth. We don't do that anymore, so we don't need that. But it's still amazed how much it flexed. It's hard to see on the camera here, but it definitely droops down in the center, and it did not used to do that. That drawbar attaches in the center of the tractor, which is right here. It's like a 12 or 14 foot drawbar that goes all the way down that tractor. He's trying to figure out what happened. Look at that. All right. So, for those that are new, we're on the last day of planning. We should have been done right now. But piece on the back of the bud is breaking off the drawbar support. I don't know what you call it, drawbar support hanger. This piece here basically is breaking off, and it's not going to hang on much longer. It's definitely cracked quite a bit through. So we're getting all the weight off this cart by loading it in the truck, which will then be dumped into this cart to finish out planting the seeds. So
yeah,
I know. Darn kids breaking everything. I agree. Just use baling wire. I just gotta go get some. There's some around here somewhere. Did yours run okay?
I found out what the problem was.
Okay.
With the wheel sender. Evidently it might be getting the sender itself was getting a little bit deep. And the distance
on the meter?
Yeah, on the meter that it counts.
Yeah.
Evidently it must have been weak because it's never changed. But I moved it in just a little bit closer and then everything goes out. So that was working good. But it's odd why it's not progressively worse. So I'm sure that it's going to probably fail eventually. It was running good.
Weird. Oh. Yeah, that's odd.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a little bit of seed. I don't know if that one piece over there will seed it all out. You can try. Let's look at the truck and see. But there probably is going to be 50 bushels by the time we're done. Yeah. Well, you can go down on...
I think what you're doing, I'm just going to pull it over and see the bottom.
Yeah.
It's a lot easier to do it during the day tomorrow.
That's it. That's fine.
What do you guys think? Let's take a vote. Okay? All those in favor of giving me a raise?
You guys got to decide. It's not my decision. I can't...
No. If I was typing that, it would probably be a razz. They said, oh yeah, we're all for that. Let's give them a razz.
They're saying thumbs up. Yeah. Thumbs up. Fire leg arms, give Dad a raise. All right. I could lock it. Oh, he's not in anymore. I say he was in there. I could have locked him in it.
Look what he's doing.
He's always playing his camera.
Yeah, he's doing something for you guys in about a month.
Yeah. That guy. Nobody likes him. At least a few of you do.
I do. I've got three.
You got a bunch of thumbs up.
Yeah. Well, all right. Okay. I do. I have three. Well, two and a half from him. So
yeah.
They're great.
He's got grandkids he's got to like them for. We can just stare at leg arms for a while to see what he's doing.
That's one thing about it. He's focused.
Yeah, he's got something going on there. I don't know. He could be actually counting every seed as it falls down. Isn't that slow? I know. I can't believe they didn't make a bigger opening there to drain that faster. Takes forever. The other day we did this like three times. It was really frustrating. Well, let's go dig in the dirt while we're waiting for those guys. Is that all to dump? Let's see. How about right here? Find us a bean. Gotta be one here somewhere. They're usually pretty easy to spot because they're so colorful. Oh, there's one right there. There you go. That is a garbanzo bean. Garbanzo beans are a delicacy in other parts of the world. Here in the US, there's a lot of stuff we use them for. They're really high in protein, really high in protein. Really healthy food. And it makes, if you like hummus, that's what they make hummus out of. I like hummus. I'm not like obsessed with it. My wife loves hummus. She absolutely loves hummus, but it has to be good hummus. She's so much of a hummus lover that she knows bad hummus from good hummus. It all tastes the same to me, but she knows. It's like good coffee and bad coffee. I could drink all kinds of coffee if I could. Doesn't matter. I'll drink it. Just add sugar. But there are people out there, and they know the difference. And so, yeah, it's always a search to try to find a good hummus supplier. And up, we're here in North Central Montana. There's not a lot of Middle Eastern nationalities, so which means there's not a lot of Middle Eastern restaurants, which means there's not a lot of really genuine hummus. So to get good hummus, you got to go up to Canada. Lethbridge, I think Calgary. Calgary's got a really nice place we found. And yeah, they got really good Middle Eastern food there. Really good hummus. Delicious. So yeah, I'm just waiting for someone to open a nice kibosh, whatever they call the name. Some kind of a Middle Eastern restaurant here in Shelby. That'd be awesome. And if you guys are wondering what all this is here, I did a lot of videos and stuff on and off. That thing, we can walk over there real quick. It's not ours, so I don't want to be, you know, technically it's our land, but it's, I think they got a lease on here. I'm not sure how it all works. But this right here is a compressor. And what this baby is doing, or it's basically like a pump. They call it a compressor. It is running. There's an engine in here that runs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, over and over and over and over and over. And what it does is it is pumping literally natural gas from all those little gas shacks that look like that thing right there. See that? You guys see those all the time, right? Those are all wells that are drilled throughout the property. Think of it like an oil well, only it's natural gas. So it's actually sucking natural gas up through the ground and it's pumping it to another facility down a big pipeline that runs way down that way. So pretty cool setup. There's our Fummins. Oh, they finish? It all done? Oh, good. Oh, and by the way, I haven't even used that once yet this year. I haven't had a chance. That's good. I shouldn't be complaining, but I was kind of hoping to put it to the test. I guess we're good. So, we'll lift this manifold back up, latch it. And then, that thing is stiff. And then run this thing home. I think we're going to call it a night, which means, yeah, we are officially not done with plant 2020. We'll finish tomorrow. It's too bad, but that's okay. It's only a little bit to do tomorrow, like an hour at most. So, Dad'll finish that. Get that all wrapped up, and I'll do some spraying tomorrow, a lot of spraying, get that wrapped up. And Wiggles or Wags or Brad, our hired hand right now, he's off in the 7140 Magnum rolling the chickpeas that we've seen it already. Well, I suppose I should take a pickup. Are you running your drill back to the farm?
Yeah.
Okay.
But that, we're gonna load this into my drill right now.
Oh.
Get done with that.
Okay.
And then in the morning I'll finish the, or maybe somebody, hey, anybody can get here by about 8:30 to small morning.
Anybody?
You can take over.
Yeah, we'll leave the keys in them. We have a secret spot we usually put them, but he's serious, by the way. Yeah. I could just take it home real slow. Depends what you guys want me to do. Should I stay here and watch them fill the other drill and then they take it home? Or should I drive this girl home? And if it breaks on my watch, then it's my fault. Right? Can we just drive the butt home? My pickup's up here too. I gotta get that. Limp it home! Okay. Oh, what's he doing? Crazy? Good to go?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, I'll take it easy. Make sure my cord doesn't snag.
There we go.
Woo! Oh, there. Okay, I'm finally alone. Guys, it was totally Legarm's fault. I saw him back there. You should have seen it. Took this jump. Told him not to do it. He wasn't on camera at the moment, but he did it. It was pretty cool, but after the thought, I really don't think it was as cool as it should have been. This thing, I gotta turn the air conditioner off.
All right, let's boogie out of here. Get on the county road. Start this camera. I would stick my magnet from this camera to the somewhere in this cab, but I don't want to scratch the paint because it's so shiny in here after we painted everything. So I've been refraining from sticking my camera to places in this cab. Usually I do with the other tractors. You just stick the camera on and you're good. But so I might have to find a place to hook this thing. All right. Oh, I gotta do it this way. Turn this off. Just pulling up on the county road. And there we go. Perfect. Okay. I don't know how fast to go, but we will put her in a wide angle camera. So I'm in high one, let's go to two. Go three. I'm just not gonna throttle up real hard. What's this? 10 miles an hour, 11? Yeah, it's kind of bouncing a little bit. Let's go a little slower. It's gonna be a long drive home. There we go. What are we doing? 6.5 miles an hour? Oh boy. Well, a little longer trip home versus breaking down in the middle of county road. We'll take that. And by the way, this road was underwater last year, or a year, 2 years ago. Now we seeded those bottoms. Isn't that crazy? That was all lake bed. And now it's planted. All right, so people are wondering what happened. Basically, we don't know. I was out there helping leg arms unplug some of the runs, the boots, and I happened to look at the drawbar on this tractor, and I noticed it looked like it was sinking or sagging a little bit. And the bracket that holds the drawbar up is breaking off. It's literally fracturing off from the mounts that hold it on the back of the tractor. And it could break off at any moment, which would then drop the whole drawbar in the ground. This thing would drag pretty good. So we just got it all emptied. I'm just gonna take this tractor back, limp the tractor home, and then that way, hopefully, it makes it back to the farmyard, and then we can unhook it and deal with it there. That's the plan. So that's what's going on. Drive it like I stole it. All right. I'm just trying to find a speed where it doesn't hop. That's not bad right there. You know what's way better though? If I turn the auto steer on while I'm going down the county road. Because that's definitely not frowned upon. So let's go GPS. Let's go heading. Let's shift the line over, set to current. Line is shifted, turn on the auto steer. Going too fast, it says. Try it again. How fast do I need to? Oh, there we go. All right, auto steer's engaged. There we go. Okay. It's steering itself down the county road now. That's nice. Under 10 miles an hour, that's what I think I'm going to do. I'm at 11.4 right now. We'll just keep it like that. That's a good speed. What are the names on the windshield? So those are names from our patrons. And they both are called Legendary Farm Legends on our Patreon page. And they pay a monthly amount and they get their names inside the tractors as well as like early access to videos. You guys can check it out. We have a Patreon. It should be in the description below in one of our videos. But so we got Logan Bruins and Nathan Dunlop and they support us that way. It's pretty cool. We signed up for Patreon because we had a fan tell us once, hey, I support other patrons and I'd like to have you guys as a patron, but you don't have an account set up. So I was like, all right, well, we'll just make one and to see how it goes, and you just make different tiers, you offer different things, different tiers, and it's amazing how many people have been a part of it. So it's been really, really cool. But yeah, that's why there's names in the tractor. A lot of our vehicles, you'll see those names randomly spread out around. And those are, they call them farm legends. So that's how it is. All right. Auto steering down the road. I see I got traffic coming towards me, so I'll have to get off the road here in a little bit and let it by. But do I rock pick? Yeah, I do. I do rock pick. I don't rock pick a lot, but we have a rock picker, and I did go out with it about a week ago. Need to do more. Let's see here. Is anyone in the 435? I don't think so. I don't think so. I'll have to double check. I don't think so. The only thing is with these tractors is, like, the 435 is not going to get used a lot. So, you know, it's not a... I hate to have someone put their name in something that, you know, never gets used very much. But you definitely can. Definitely not saying don't. Do we lease any land? Yeah, we lease a lot of land.
Probably my nose went on.
We lease quite a bit of land. Probably about a quarter of all of our land is leased. Maybe a fifth. I don't know, something like that. So, yeah. What camera do you use? Right now I'm using the DJI Osmo Action, which is this guy in a case. It's all set up. That's a battery pack in my handle here. Charges the camera so it doesn't run out of battery. Literally can run about almost 2 days without charging. Very nice. I gotta pull over, let this car go by. I'll show you what I'm doing here. So let's get over on the side of the road here. I don't feel like running anyone over today. Some days, maybe. Not today. Let this person drive by. Huh. I think I've seen them before. Okay. No one's passing us, so I guess no one was behind us. Let's get back in line here. Let's grab that auto steer line. There we go. Let the tractor steer itself down the county road. As nice as this county road is, pretty true north and south. I can just set my AV line and just let it take it down it. There we go. Okay. Turn off my AccuTurn. I don't want that to turn. What's your favorite truck brand? I was always a General Motors guy, GM. But I do like the new Fords. Now, if you're talking semi-trucks, I'd probably say something along the lines of Peterbilt, probably is my favorite. Kenworth, probably second. I really like Mack trucks, so they're probably third. And I don't know, there's a lot of good truck companies out there. Western Star International, they make, I think, pretty good trucks, but yeah. Let's see here. Real Super Chats, I know. Oh, we got, oh, Reed Super Chats. Ah, got it. Yeah, I'm sorry. It's been a little crazy. New Zealand, Robert, thank you for the $2. Appreciate it. Cougar 588, $10. Great channel. Use this $10, some good use. We could use it to help rebuild this tractor. That shouldn't need any work. We just got done going to it. I appreciate the Super Chat. Jack, $2. Can I just wish you the best of seeding 2020? You sure can. Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Bill K, 820, for the 82,000 still unaccounted for POWs, MIAs missing since World War II. Keep flying that flag. They're not forgotten. Amen to that. 82,000. That is amazing. I imagine a lot of that is sailors and airmen, probably. POW MIA. When I was in Air Force ROTC in University of Boulder, Colorado, we would do a POW run once a year. It was a 24-hour vigilance run that we would take turns running the POW flag, and it would never stop. So you'd start running it on the hour, and it would go 24 hours, and a cadet would always have the flag. And so we would just take turns throughout the night and throughout the day, taking shifts running that flag, and we run like 2 or 3 miles at a time, probably. Maybe I don't know, but yeah, probably about 2 or 3 miles. And then we'd hand it off the next group of cadets, the next group of cadets, and so you do it. And it was pretty cool. You don't really think about prisoners of war. That's what POW means. POW. MIA is missing in action. So either a prisoner of war, where they're in another nation's prison camp, or they're missing in action, they never came home. whether an airplane crashed or they were shot, killed, and never found, who knows. So it's really a lot of soldered A2000s. It's pretty amazing. But yeah, that's I made a video today, actually. They do it on Memorial Day. So I hope it works out pretty good, because I do like to take... I really appreciate our military and those that have served. Even though I never fully served, I just definitely appreciate that. So, am I from Indiana? No, I'm from Montana. Good old Montana. So far, it's not dragging back there. We're good. I saw someone say, go Buffs. I actually only went to one Buff game. Only one. The whole time I was there. I didn't actually live in Boulder, so I didn't spend a lot of time in Boulder outside of ROTC. And I didn't go to the University of Boulder. But, yeah, that's kind of a very interesting town. City. Very interesting city. Some very interesting people there. Good people. There's good people there. Then there's weird people. Anthony M. Carrier, $2. Give Lazy Acres a shout-out on YouTube, North Carolina Farm. Thank you. I could do that, Laser. Adam Irwin, $2. You guys are awesome. Thanks for sharing. Thank you, Adam. Anonymous Person, $2. Has COVID-19 impacted your farming life at all? Not really. It really hasn't a lot. If it's impacted us, it's been more or less just how we feel about how the rest of the country is doing. Our local businesses, most of them that are farm or ag related, were able to keep going. They didn't have to shut down. Like Subway closed for a month, and that was kind of a bummer because that's one of the few places we can eat in Shelby, Montana. But they're back. Montana lifted its restrictions quite a bit, so things are looking good there. Yeah, it's not really affected the ag industry that much. Prices, it might have affected our prices a little bit with some of our commodities because some of the ports shut down. And there was some backlog of some of the crops. But overall, no, it's not at all like what someone who lives in the city, who works at a business in a city who can't go to work, supposed to stay home all the time. I nothing changed in my life. I don't stay at home. I go to work. I've been working the whole time through this, pretty long hours and a lot of days. So it's not like my life's really changed that much. But it has affected a lot of people, and I'm sure the negative effects of it are going to trickle back to the farm eventually here. There's going to be, the economy can't take a hit like this and not see effects. So we'll see it some way or one way or another. But well, I guess one positive thing though about it is our diesel prices went really low. Diesel's really cheap right now. So driving big rigs like this, burning 10,000 gallons of diesel in a month, isn't as bad as you think. Because it's like 10,000 times $1.50. So $15,000 of fuel we burn. Is that right? This spring planting, 15 grand. Well, there's been times where it's been like 25 grand. So saving $10,000 because of COVID due to diesel costs, that's a good thing to be thankful for, but not a lot of things to be thankful for. So I live about 40 minutes from Zach Johnson. I am so sorry. I don't know how you handle it. Poor guy, you should move. Get out of there. It's just one of those guys, you know. Soon we'll hang out one of these days. He's a character. A lot of good farm channels out there, guys. Not just Welker Farms. If you guys follow, there's a number of them. I'd love to just start naming them off, but I'd forget some, and then I'd feel bad for the ones I forget. But just know there's a lot of good farm channels out there. A lot of really interesting different perspectives of farming. So, Dodge Boulder, Colorado. When did you go to CU Boulder? Well, I went to Metropolitan State College in Denver, downtown Denver, for 4 years, from 2006 to 2009. Graduated in 2009. And during that time, I went to Air Force ROTC, Det 105, Detachment 105, at CU for two and a half of those years. So I spent time in Boulder while being a cadet. So yeah, 2006 to 2009. So I learned a lot. Got to spend a lot of time. I lived in Littleton, I lived in Broomfield, I lived in Westminster, and I got a lot of friends and family down there still. So yeah, it's got more traffic coming. I gotta get off the road here. I know, auto steer, you want to go in the middle of the road because I told you to. Let these guys go by. Bunch of high schoolers out driving around.
definitely a bunch of high schoolers out driving around. And here comes a Cadillac. Oh boy. They must be from the same party. Only one person in that. No, wait, no, there's more. There's definitely more in there. Alright, well, no one passed us. Wait, oh, there we go. Leg Arms is back there. Oh, is he gonna do that? Seriously? No, I guess not. I thought he was gonna smoke us. Okay. Let's go. Alright, we're rolling. Getting close, being back. It's kind of funny because a lot of the people now, I don't even know them anymore. I used to. When I grew up here, I used to know most of the people in town. Between all my classmates, all my friends' friends, everybody. It's like you kind of had an idea who lived in Shelby, Montana. Out of like 3,000 people, I knew a lot of them. Now it's amazing. I don't know that many anymore. I'm so far out of the school system that I don't know any of these new kids coming up. But they all know me. Which is kind of weird. It's kind of funny. Because people are like, hey, how's it going? And you know that they're totally talking to you because they know who you are. And I'm like, I don't know who you are. I feel kind of bad about it. But I definitely, yeah, pretty fun. All right, we are almost here, guys. We're almost in the farmyard. I think we're going to make it. This tractor survived Plant 2020. It was a rough one for it, but it survived it. I'll pull in the yard here and we'll drop this air drill. Probably we need to wash it out, so get it all cleaned up, put everything away. So I probably won't unload it completely, but we'll just park in the yard for now and we'll deal with this tomorrow. There's the farmyard. Looking really green. Notice the grass is just growing like crazy. I love this time of the year. We don't have green grass all year. We get green grass for like 3 months. So we enjoy every second of it. And then it goes away and turns brown. All right, I'm just gonna drive on the grass here. We'll just put this right over here. Like that. Okay, parking brake. Let's turn off some of these items that we don't need anymore because we're done with this tractor. It's not doing any more spring planting. This definitely not. So iPad off. This will turn off when I turn the key off. Got a lot of gear in here. Got cameras, got all kinds of stuff. And yeah, that good. He's got my drone down there. I notice my screen sure looks kind of fuzzy. So, let's let this cool down. I'll walk into the shop. And then, yeah. We'll be sayonara. Say goodbye. But let's answer some questions for you guys real quick. Because I'm here, not driving. You have my full undivided attention. So, let me answer some stuff. Adam Irwin, $2. You guys are awesome. Thanks for sharing. Thank you. Glad it was a little bit of an exciting 3 hours for you. If you guys have been watching for 3 hours straight, you're amazing. Cody Shilhanek, $2. Are the big butts highway worthy? We can drive on highways, yes. We technically can. They don't have to be licensed, but we should have wide load signs. We should have lights on it. We should have flaggers. But yes, we can drive on the highway. Farmers have an exception. Bakio Canada, $10. God bless. He's from a honey farm in Manitoba. Have a great year, boys. That's awesome. I love honey. Thank you. Michael, $2. How much are the buds worth? You know, that's a really tough question. It's really hard. They're such an oddball machine as far as there's only so many of them out there. Some people value them a lot more than others. I think in today's electronic age, they've become a little more valuable. A lot of guys want to get back to big old iron that don't want to mess with electronics. But this tractor, after everything we've done to it, especially after we fixed that.
and a couple more items to it. I would say it could be worth between $100,000 and $150,000 is what it probably should be worth. I don't know if it would go for that. I've seen some big buds I thought that were in pretty good shape go for like $60,000, $70,000, so. But with this one, with all the stuff, it's, oh well, actually I take that back. If you count this system in there, the auto steer guidance system integrated, it's definitely worth, yeah, $150 at least, because it's one of a kind big bud. There's none of them out there that have a Pro 700 like that integrated auto steer. This is the only one. So yeah, with that in the mix, yeah, it would be worth definitely more. That's a, I forgot about that. That's a new, definitely, Case IH, thank you. Shout out to Case IH, our channel sponsor. They've been sponsoring us, and they're a great company to work with. Really a good company. So definitely enjoy our time with Case IH. They've been really awesome to us. Ben, Nick, can you let my Maria know that Ben loves her? Maria, no. Okay, Maria, if you're watching, Ben loves you. Just so you know, thanks for $2, Ben. I hope it's real love, nothing fake. Gaming parody, no, Ben, I'm sure it's real, Ben. Maria, are you watching, Maria? I hope you got that. Gaming parody, $2, good morning from Greece, wow. That's amazing. Okay, Leg Arms is waiting for me to get in the truck, so McLean, $1. I was gonna go in the shop, but after this cools down a little bit, which I wasn't driving it very fast down the road. So I can shut that off. This turns off automatically in a second here. And there we go. Data is being saved. All right. Let me record something real fast as I get out of this tractor. Huh, made it. Made it back. Did break off. That's a success, I would say. I gotta hold this camera. There we go. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so it's back in the yard, and we transferred everything over to Dad's drill. He's gonna finish planting that tomorrow. We'll deal with this, and we'll get the drill unhooked and unbolt that bracket there and find out what in the world happened. But yeah, pretty crazy. So a couple more things to do. Unfortunately, I can't say officially that we're done with planting because we have a little bit more to do tomorrow, like an hour's worth. So that's okay. We'll get it done. But in my book, we're done. I'm gonna go get in the truck with the Leg Arms. I don't know where he wants to take me, but he wants to go somewhere, so I better get in. I know, they're still with us after like 3 hours.
Can I, can I say something?
Yeah.
You're a man of many talents.
Well, I don't know about that.
Oh, wow, he made good time.
Where'd my glasses go?
We might as well wait for him. Because
my glasses in there?
They're in there.
Do we need another vehicle up there?
Your pickup in the truck.
Right, yeah.
We forgot to shut the lid on.
I noticed the color's kind of, did he?
I forgot to.
Oh. I know what's going on with my phone. The color's kind of like blurry or kind of red.
Lens,
no, it's. I think it's my phone. I think it's in some of the app. Hopefully they're not seeing that. So, okay. Leg Arms is a man of many arms.
I have like four. Or four legs.
Four Leg Arms.
You know what's sad?
Huh.
Is I was getting to a point where I was getting like strong and I was feeling healthy and like starting to lose some weight. And then this COVID thing happened. And now like I've got like flab. There's like nothing.
See,
there.
He's one to talk though, because I am so weak right now. I'm not kidding. My back, my legs, everything on my body is so weak, and I used to be very strong.
Used to be freakishly freakish.
Yeah, I used to be really strong, and it's not there anymore. And I really want to get it back. I really want to get it back. So I'm hoping to get some time.
Thing is though, like when you build muscle, it's hard to get it the first time, but the second time or third time that you try to go back to it, it
seems to come back quicker.
It comes back faster. And your strength, though, that's the thing, is getting endurance and strength, that takes a little longer.
Yeah.
But
it's called aging. Yeah, I know.
Oh.
Having kids, getting older, just how it is.
Well, so, made
poor
it.
Nick, I know. Oh, yeah, we also picked up someone else. I don't know how, but something is in the back there. Couldn't leave him behind. That wouldn't be right. Would you ever become an ag pilot? No, I don't think I would. Not really a lot of business in this area for ag pilots. And it's a dangerous job too. And I don't have my commercial pilot's license, so I couldn't do it without getting more pilot's license for pilot training. But yeah. I was, let's see, I'm from Kentucky, awesome. Try arthritis in the spine. Ooh, it sucks. That would be terrible. Yeah, that would be really bad. I don't think I have arthritis in my spine, but I wrecked a four-wheeler really bad a few years ago, and I've had back pain ever since. I've had chiropractic work and stuff done, but it's hurting right now, and I don't know why.
Don't you have, like, some phase, like, some hazy memories because of it?
Yeah, I lost some memory because of that. I don't know. I can't remember. I mean, I don't know how much I lost, but I know there's some areas that I don't really have very much memory of. So, bad concussions. Four-wheelers don't mix. What is my favorite Big Bud? Well, the one I was just in until it broke. I don't know who did it. One of these guys.
Not me.
Yeah, he didn't do it.
No way.
He's been in the other tractor the whole time.
I see it at 4,600, and I'll probably get another 50, 60 tomorrow.
So we got about almost 4,300 in this one.
You have 43?
Almost 43, I thought, right?
I said 38. When
38.
I was,
oh, 38?
Yeah. Yeah, I was like 38 or 37 or something.
Yeah, I was looking at the wrong one, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got a few acres in. I was talking to a guy in Australia, and he just put 5,000 acres on a 40-foot disc drill. And they got another 5,000 or 6,000 to go, 7,000 to go.
Wow. How fast are they able to see?
They're 7 miles an hour, 6 miles an hour, but they go 24/7.
Yeah.
Wow. They just, they have shifts, and the tractor just keeps going around the clock. But they do that because the combines, the drills, everything has tire tracks in the same spots, he said. So the compaction is in the exact same spots every time, regardless. RTK, because they don't get frost over there, so compaction is a bigger issue.
Right.
So everything is set up to drive the same tracks everywhere they go. I still can't believe they don't have one more drill, though. That'd be amazing. I don't know.
Wow.
Yeah. Crazy. How big is your fuel barrel? You mean the fuel tank. That'd be excited. You're talking the big white tank? 16,000. 400 barrel?
Yeah, it's 400. It comes out to a little over 16,000.
A little over 16,000 gallons. So, yeah, fully topped off. We never really get it 100% topped off, but, yeah.
We can do some more because there's about 8,000 in it right now.
Says some parts of Australia get frost. Oh, some parts do? Okay.
We're up about
4,000 gallons of it?
Well, yeah, seeding and then also you spray it.
Well, I guess maybe I overestimated how much fuel we burn. I figured 3/4 acre.
It's 6/10.
Oh, 6/10 of a gallon?
What I figure all the time, it's about 6/10 a gallon. And there's a...
You guys want to see that porcupine?
Nah, that's fine. We can get back to our trucks. Fill it up with diesel. It's cheap. It is cheap, and it's probably going to stay cheap for a while.
Yeah,
we filled it up when it was cheaper, but not the cheapest. But it's probably only dropped about 20 cents since we did it.
I don't even know about that.
Not even that much?
No.
So,
I think...
Fuel's a little more expensive up here because there's refineries. We're far from the coast, down in the Gulf, so it takes a little bit more to get the fuel up here. But I've heard of fuel under a buck in a lot of places, so yeah, that's pretty cool. We're at like $1.70 for gas, I think. So, but anyways, here's where I'm going to jump into my pickup and head home. So I think this is a good place to call her quits. But thanks, guys, for being a part of this 3 hours and 18-minute live stream.
How many people are still watching?
I can't believe AT&T hasn't cut off my phone data. There's about 2,800 people, 2,900 people still. So, thanks, guys.
Sweet.
Thanks for breaking the tractor. I bet you if we weren't in a live stream, it wouldn't have broke.
I'm sorry.
You guys.
I'm sorry.
Well, they're
sorry for being bossy.
They're going to want to know.
Stuff.
Yeah, he broke
I'm sorry for just being here, actually.
That's why we tried to fire him a long time ago.
Yeah.
Just can't get rid of these people.
I'm trying very hard to get fired, but you guys won't let me go.
I don't know. I haven't figured it out.
Anyway. All I know is we got a good broker.
Yeah.
True.
Fortunately, we don't need that tractor for a little while. We do need to get it fixed soon, though, because we do have some plans for it coming up here. But it's nice that we're at the tail end, the very almost end of planting. So, well, let's just call us. We're finished with plant 2020, minus that little bit tomorrow that you guys aren't going to tell anyone about. Sound good? All right. Okay, we'll catch you guys later.
See
God
guys.
Bless. Have a good one. Thanks for being a part of the stream. And, watch today's video, too. That'll add another 20 minutes to your day. Okay. Later. My back actually.